really happen. And that's just the honest truth, because behind something spectacular like this, there always is an incredibly passionate and driven person who puts almost everything into it to make it work. And you know who I'm talking about. I'm talking about Heidi Solba, who is the president of Let's Do It World. And to speak to her, we have to go back to the headquarters in Tallinn in Estonia. Heidi, can you give us our opening remarks, please, and tell us how you're feeling today?
Hello, can you hear me, I hope, and you can see me as well. I'm doing really well. I'm so grateful and really honored to speak on behalf of all the Let's Do It World and to say that you are so welcome to our annual conference. All our partners, all our friends, and all the Let's Doers around the world, from east to west, from north to south, which does have one face, which is the face of the human who does know that we have to change the world. And that's why we are Let's Doers, because we are doing. We are not just sitting talking, but we are doing as well. And for me, the Let's Do It World is like the great humans who just have really huge spirit and passion, of course, and who do know that we have to change the world. And we are doing a lot from ourselves. Furthermore, we are bringing a lot of people together and showing the really great example how we can actually collaborate, because the collaboration, I think, is a key word. And this is interesting that the life itself have put the huge boundaries for the COVID-19. And this is the main reason why we cannot come together. But therefore, we have to be strong. And I think that we are working by coming together in this year and next year. We have to believe, and we have to be strong in order to carry what we already have done and to carry this work, what we are doing, and to carry with all the partnerships. This is really important, to work with the governments, to work with huge organizations around the world. And we have done it already really well, and we will continue definitely. So saying all that, I really say huge thank you for all the Let's Do It Indonesia team, Let's Do It Germany team, who is also working on this conference, to HQ, Let's Do It World headquarters in Tallinn, but also to all the Let's Do It World network people, all the leaders and all the teams and all the people who are here. Thank you for the trust. Thank you for the work what we are carrying. Thank you for your big hearts. And let's carry this great opportunity here and let's get inspired. Huge thank you. Have a really nice conference. And we will see there and in this session and this session. So really happy to see our family here. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Heidi. And we'll go back to Heidi in Tallinn, Estonia in just a few minutes for the lighting of the candle, the official start of the conference. And at the end of the conference, she will extinguish that candle. So it's a really beautiful moment. And we look forward to that in just a few minutes. Now, we are going to head to Indonesia. But before we go and speak to Agustina, we want to show you a special treat, because, of course, Indonesia, one of the most populous country in the world, I think the third most populous country in the world, but Agustina can tell me if I was right or not in that geography. It is known, of course, for its scenic beauty, its over 2,000 islands, but also its diversity, its culture, and its vibrancy, its music and its dance. So here's a special treat just for us here at the conference. This is a traditional Indonesian dance from the region of Acehnese, and this is called the Ratoeh Jaroe dance. Take it away.
Assalamualaikum.
Syarat mulia,
pakai doa.
That was really stunning. That was so beautiful. And a huge thank you to the group there and the traditional dance from the Acehnese region of Indonesia. That was a Ratoeh Jaroe dance. And just so beautiful to see the traditional outfits, the costumes, the setting, the house behind them, and the unspoiled beauty as well, which reminds us again of why we are doing this. Let's stick with Indonesia and let's go now to our host country and to speak to Agustina Iskandar, who is leading the charge over there. Agustina, how are you today? And tell us a bit about this conference that's ahead of us and why it's important for you, for Indonesia, and for everyone taking part.
Hello. Thank you. Oh, so happy to see everyone here. Hello. Welcome to the World Conference 2022. We are so happy to get this opportunity to host a conference. It is a big momentum for all of us, the one who was involved in working up the world together, to celebrate a cycle of World Cleanup Day and to unite us for a waste-free world. I remember 2022 was at annual conference in Estonia. It was winter, really cold outside, really warm inside, where all our was gathering and full of love and energy. That moment, Let's Do It Germany team was inviting me to have lunch together. We were discussing how countries we can work together to have a collaboration, and maybe we can do something to lead the conference. And this is how the idea was coming. The concept was born. So thank you for Germany team to bring us together, to bring the people together that we are. I mean, last year when Germany team was hosting the conference, Indonesia as a supporting team, and this year when Indonesia as a hosting countries, Germany team also support the conference. This is really cool collaborations. Thank you so much, and of course, thank you, huge thank you for our Let's Do It World, the one and only our umbrella of day. This will not happen without the Let's Do It World team. So who always there working with us, hands on hands, you know, to make everything is. And of course, really huge thank you as well for Indonesia team. Such a honor for me to work with this wonderful team, which is they just so wonderful, working really hard. The in Indonesia to support all the working update activities, like so special for us, because our Ministry of Environment and Forestry, the General Director Rosa, Vivien, is coming, and so it's just wonderful for us to have her here with all of us. And thank you so much, Heidi Solba, our President, lovely President. Everyone love Heidi, right? And Walsmann later on will give the speech. Of European Parliament, and Roberta Metsola, the President of European Parliament as well. So it's so cool to have everyone here. And of course, for all the country leaders and the partners from more than 100 to come here tonight, and Indonesia is already, but today for all of you, maybe or in the morning for some countries. So thank you so much for coming here. We are not here if believe on the same values, operations, positivity, our values. This is the reason why we are here, to stay back for a waste-free world. That's because we believe on the same. Not happen if we don't work together. So thank you so much. Enjoy the conference and stay with us until Sunday, 30/2022. Back to you, Colm.
Augustina, you're such a professional, Augustina. Back to you, Colm. And by the way, everyone, I think you'll agree, Augustina looks like a movie star. Look at this, the hair and the... Hang on a second, Augustina. I can't be on screen with you when you're looking like that. Let me just get a bit of this makeup going. And is that okay? Am I looking a bit better, Augustina? Yeah. Okay, Augustina, thank you. And for those passionate remarks, and we'll hear more from you later as the host country. But now you mentioned your local Indonesian government. Of course, it is so important to get the help of local authorities, national authorities, and international authorities who really come on board with us at Let's Do It. And now we're going to hear from a member of the European Parliament. This is Marion Walsmann, who sent us this message.
Dear activists, dear change makers, dear Heidi and team, I'm honored to be here today to take a stand for a waste-free world. It is my third year participating as an ambassador of the World Cleanup Day Germany. And with every year that passes, I am more convinced of the impact you are all making. It is inspiring that despite the pandemic, more and more people are joining this movement. This was the case as well last year in my home state, Thuringia, and I strongly believe that we will be able to bring even more people on board with us this year. I'm very glad that I could win our brand new president of the European Parliament, Ms. Roberta Metsola, to send us a video message for the opening today. She was directly on board when I asked her to do a video message for the World Cleanup Day movement. She accepted my request right away, even though she has a very tight schedule. I highly respect Roberta Metsola. She is a young politician from Malta, a true European, and as a mother of four children, a real example of how to manage job and family at the same time. We all have the same aim of a sustainable future for us and for our kids. And events like this are one step into the right direction. Let's do this step today and also do many more steps together in the future. I wish us all a successful event, and I'm happy to show you now the video message of Roberta Metsola, the President of the European Parliament.
And I have just come in here to second what she said and hand over to Roberta Metsola, the President of the European Parliament.
Dear hosts, dear guests, dear participants, the transition to a greener, more sustainable tomorrow is not only important to me in my institutional capacity, but also in my personal one. This is a fight that we cannot afford to lose, and we are the last generation of politicians who can do something about it. The sense of urgency is real. Soon we will have more plastic in our oceans than we have fish. My children grow up around images of turtles strangled by decades-old plastic waste. Let's do it, world. You are one of the largest global environmental initiatives. My hope is that the example that you are setting in the world is mirrored. Because if we truly want to create a sustainable tomorrow, this is on all of our shoulders. I am proud that the European Parliament has taken the lead on this. In recent years, we have made the first steps to ban single-use plastics once and for all, and we have further mainstreamed the polluter pays principle. Only this week, the European Parliament chaired a public hearing on plastics and waste management in the circular economy in order to take stock of citizens' concerns with the impact of plastics on the environment and, in particular, with the end-of-life stage of plastics. But it is not only about legislation. The changes that we all make in buying practices can make a huge difference. This conference is an opportunity to raise awareness on how, together, we can make the shift to a better system of waste management and a greener, waste-free world for us and for our children. During the conference, we may be inspired by success stories about initiatives across the globe that actively play their part in combating waste and plastics. However, we will also hear heartbreaking accounts that remind us, and we know this all too well, that there is still much left to be done. Cleaning up the world can only get us so far unless together we make changes to our daily consumer habits. There is a lot to discuss, so let's get to it. Let's kick off this Let's Do It conference. I wish you every success in your exchanges. Thank you again for the opportunity to show my support for cleaning up our planet.
Thank you very much for that. That was the President of the European Parliament, Roberta Metsola. And two things very quickly she said that shocked me. One was when you hear that we are soon going to get to a time when there'll be more plastic than fish in the ocean. And that's a very frightening proposition. But the other thing that was very encouraging when she acknowledged that Let's Do It is one of the largest global environmental initiatives in the world. Isn't that incredible? Recognized by the European Parliament. So it's a testament to all the great work that you've been putting in, building this from the ground up over the past number of years. Now let's go back to Indonesia very quickly, because we're going to say hello and get a video message from the General Director of Ministry for the Environment, Forestry as well. And their name is Rosa Vivien Ratnawati.
Dear all guests and participants, can you hear my voice?
Yes, we can indeed. Okay. Oh, and it's live, not a video message. Sounds good, loud and clear.
Thank you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening from Indonesia. on behalf of Minister of Environment and Forestry of Republic of Indonesia, Dr. Siti Nurbaya, I would like to thank you for the invitation for joining this important conference, Let's Do It World Conference. It is my honor to be here gathering with good people who are concerned about waste and cleanliness from all over the world. I do hope you all are in well condition and good health and pandemic COVID-19 that is still spreading around the globe. Please stay alert and follow health protocol at any time and anywhere. I'm happy since now waste issues, especially plastic waste, are becoming global concern. Government, academia, business, and civil society have put waste problem as a priority issue. I am the person who is responsible for national solid waste management in Indonesia, feeling so delighted to have more friends and colleagues to overcome waste challenges. I do believe that Let's Do It World Together with World Cleanup Day as part of civil society movement could help the government to combat waste challenges here in Indonesia. Civil society movement is the power that we could not be ignored. Waste that I refer to garbage is left over from our daily lives, from individual, household, neighborhood, city to country. Each person as a producer of waste, so by our law, everyone should be responsible for waste that he or she produce by managing it properly. How to manage our waste properly as sustainably? Practicing the 3 R's principle, reduce, reuse, and recycle. The 3 R's, some people use 5 R's or even 7 R's, is basic principle to implement environmentally friendly and sustainable waste management that alter an ecological and unsustainable waste management that is collect, transfer, and dump. This 3 R's principle is main spirit of our solid waste management in Indonesian regulation. By practicing 3 R's, we can reduce negative impact our waste to environment and human health by avoiding waste generation in daily lives and circulating our waste using reuse and recycle methods. At the same time, we can use and utilize our virgin resource efficiently. In the philosophy of sustainable solid waste management, no waste or avoid to waste process poses at the highest hierarchy of kindness since it doesn't generate impact to the environment and human health. And it based on the highest knowledge, consciousness, and commitment. In this case, we already put that philosophy into our policy and practice in form of Gerakan Gaya Hidup Minim Sampah or Less Waste Lifestyle Movement. As the power that cannot be ignored, I ask Let's Do It World for working together with government to spread out and materialize Gaya Hidup Minim Sampah or Less Waste Lifestyle Movement at the community level by implementing the new ways as follows. Take appropriate meal and do not waste your food. Buy what you need, you wish. Buy what you need, not you wish. Bring your own reusable bag, refuse plastic bag. Drink your beverage without plastic straw, refuse it. Bring your own tumbler, bring your own reusable cutlery sets, Bring your own handkerchief, refuse tissue, but it is still difficult, yeah? Bring your own reusable meal box, refuse styrofoam container. If we still produce waste, the next step that I need help from Let's Do It World is make waste separation, segregation as our daily habit. Waste separation is a key success to further manage our waste properly, since segregated and clean waste is easy to compost, reuse, and recycle. Lastly, I would like to appreciate Let's Do It World for amazing efforts that already conducted and plan to implement to keep our planet clean and livable for generations to come. I'm proud that Let's Do It World has decided Indonesia as host country of this world-class conference. Thank you. Terima kasih.
Thank you very much for those beautiful words. That was the General Director of the Ministry of Environment and Forestry in Indonesia, Rosa Vivien Ratnawati. And I loved her passion as well. And practical advice on ways to cut down, reduce, reuse and recycle. So thank you very much. And thank you for the government's help in Indonesia over the past number of years. Indonesia have always come out with record-breaking numbers in terms of a cleanup each year for the World Cleanup Day. Now we are heading back to the Let's Do It World headquarters in Tallinn in Estonia. This is a really special moment. It is the official lighting of the candle. So let's hand back now to Heidi.
Actually, we do have really lovely tradition over the years. And this is this lovely candle, which we are lighting each time when we are holding this conference. And it brings the light and the wisdom and the warmth to our hearts and to our minds to follow us through all the conference. With us here today, I'd like to just say that we are really proud to have some guests as well. We have really great leaders from United States, Bill, David from UK, Anna from France, and our HQ team. Not all the HQ team, by the way, is here. But this is like, my wish is that we actually can gather in reality. But anyhow, let's light this candle and let's warm our hearts and our minds. And here it is, showing us the light, how we actually can serve the world where we are living. So thank you so much. And we are continuing with our lovely music here with Pila and Farishtamo, which is also nice gifts from the headquarters. Please enjoy. And this is opening of their conference. Please.
Stunning music there from our talented team in the headquarters. And that was a beautiful lighting of the candle ceremony. Thank you, Heidi. Good to see Bill there as well from the USA back in town. Bill is trouble. He's trouble, but we'll be hearing more from him later in the conference. Now that we've officially opened up the conference with the lighting of the candle, we are very much underway. So we are now going to start our first session. And this is the success stories. We're going to be hearing from a number of them in quick succession. And we're starting with a fascinating country on many fronts. We're starting with China. And the title of the talk there is City Cleanup Plan to Break Through in China. Hey, there's our friend back. I can see her loud and clear. How are you? You're good. I think you need to unmute your microphone so we can hear you. And this is Juan Nu. Juan, we're heading over to you. And we're still not hearing you yet. I'll put up some groove music while you get it going. Let's see, I am not hearing you or any of the other speakers hearing you at the moment. No, not yet. Let's see, you have your microphone unmuted, you have the correct microphone selected. If you want, you can do your entire talk through interpretive dance, and I will say what I think you mean by interpreting your dance moves. That might not work well though. Otherwise, we're going to admire that green hair. Now, give us a sound test of 1, 2, 3, 1, and we'll see if we can hear. No, we are still not hearing you unless it's something on my end. Can anyone else hear? Give thumbs up if someone can hear her. No, we're not hearing you, Juan, yet. This is live. This is what happens during a live conference. These are the little teething problems, we call them. Now, we're going to get it sorted in just a second. We have technical experts in Estonia and in Germany and all over the world working on this, and there are messages popping up on my screen. You know what, Juan? What we might do is we'll go to the next speaker and we'll come back to you in just a moment. Is that okay with you? But you hang right there. Okay, yeah, and we'll fix your sound. So we're going to skip to Sweden from China, Cleaner Sweden. And the question is it possible to have a cleaner Sweden? We often think of the Scandinavian countries as very clean and pristine, but let's find out as we go to Johanna Ragnartz. I hope I pronounced that right. Johanna.
Perfectly. Can you hear me?
I can hear you perfectly.
Okay,
too.
Great.
Johanna, we will go over to you. You are the country leader of Let's Do It Sweden and CEO of Keep Sweden Tidy. Johanna, over to you.
Well, thank you very much for being part of this. Now I'm trying to do another technical thing, that is sharing a presentation. So we'll see if it works. No, I can't. Host disabled participant screen sharing. Maybe now? No. So I have to ask the technical support to share my presentation.
Yeah, I think Johanna or administrators might make you an administrator so that you can share your presentation. But I like the look of where you are. It looks nice and green. If you move your head for a second, what's behind you? Move your head to the side. It's a little, what is that? Is it a slide or is
it's
it
like
a little
trail. It's like a trail.
A little trail.
Over some water, I think.
Johanna,
in the north.
Do me a favor, just while we're waiting for you to be made an administrator, will you walk down that trail for us and come back again?
I will try.
There you go. Come back, Johanna. I was joking. We nearly lost
Joanna. Oh, really?
We nearly lost
Joanna. Now we'll see if I can do this. And I should share my screen, right?
There we go.
Yeah, but this is no fun.
And now she's back and she's fixing
this. Now I'm backing. I'm trying to find my PowerPoint, which is, it's really, really slow.
Okay, while you find your PowerPoint, I'll keep it Sweden and I'll sing some ABBA. How about that?
Yeah, I'm sorry, this is just not working.
Waterloo, I escape if I wanted to. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Waterloo.
It's like
knowing my babies to be with you.
Oh, this is tedious, isn't it?
No, don't worry. No one is noticing this. We're making this so seamless.
Oh, really? Look.
No one. It's just me and you who know this is happening. Nobody else knows.
I hope. So what's happening now then?
Well, I can see your name on screen in your presentation.
You can see my presentation and you see my summer picture.
And I see your summer picture. A cleaner Sweden, is it possible? And you're there smiling in front of me.
So great.
If you put the presentation, they will switch the slides on your behalf.
No, I don't think so. I can do it myself. So
perfect.
Over so to we're you, on. Thank you very much. So the picture of Sweden with its really clean nature is, of course, true. See? But it's also true that we found 53 million pieces of litter during only 1 week when we performed a litter monitoring. And together with you all, we share the challenge to change people's behavior and realize that litter is a problem that we actually can change. And that's why we're all here. And I hope to bring some inspiration on how we did it last year and how we plan to do it next year, maybe. So Keep Sweden Tidy is a really old foundation. We have been running campaigns to prevent littering since the beginning of the 60s. And our organization's logotype and our doings are well known. So with limited resources, even though we had some more this year, we have chosen to run the campaign under the name of Hela Sverige plockar skräp and our own logotype, translated to everyone in Sweden is part of the cleanup. But in all of our media contacts, we are linking the campaign with World Cleanup Day, of course, and the Let's Do It organization. So the Swedes also feel that they are being a part of what's going on in the world. So this is the fourth year that we have been running World Cleanup Day in September. And I start directly with the results. Last year, we had 131,600 participants. We have a population of 10 million. So you give some perspective. But apart from that, 53% of the population had seen the campaign. And we had 15 million showings on social media. So we really had great reach in the campaign, which is good, not only because of the people that participated, but also that the other ones took part of the message and started to think. So how did we do this? What was the ingredients? Well, we have learned that a key ingredient for us is the opportunity to get a cleanup kit for free. Gloves and branded plastic bags. And this is actually something that we turned to during the pandemic, because before we had big events when we gathered people, and when we couldn't do that, we started to do the sendouts, and this seemed to be really a lucky strike. This year, we distributed 9,000 kits of this kind during this year's campaign. And the receivers, so why is it so good? The receivers of the kits are really, really grateful, and they are acting or becoming super ambassadors. They are sharing the word on social media when they get their cleanup kit, and also afterwards when they're out doing the actual cleanup. So really, really important learning for us. Then this year we had the ability and some extra money because we got some funding from the government actually. So we had the ability to create reach with the campaign, and this is really what made the big difference. So this year campaign budget was really high, and we were able to buy media both in bought media and also in our own media. So we had visibility on more platforms and in more languages than before. And one channel that really turned out to be our sort of the best channel was TikTok. And the big advertisers had not yet found it. And we were all therefore able to dominate the platform, leading to a fantastic feedback from a younger group. So this is something we're going to continue with. And we also worked with an ambassador, an actor in Sweden. You see him on the left side. Doesn't say very much to you, but he's a comedian. He is very well known and struck a really nice note in the campaign. So this is a little bit what it looked like. We had outdoor media, and I'm not sure if you can see it, but in the bottom on the white outdoor poster, you can see it, something hanging out on the left-hand corner from the outdoor advertising. That is actually plastic bags. So we added some bags on the outdoor advertising campaign for people to get and immediately start doing the cleanup. PR, of course, a really important tool that also creates local pride. So we had more than 200 articles. It is actually quite a lot. And this year we put a big effort in trying to pair local media with local ambassadors in order for all the local so-called journalists to create articles with a local touch and feel. And that really increases the engagement and attracted even more to participate. And a few of these local ambassadors, we have been able to sort of not closer to us afterwards. So we are having a continuous discussion with them and are using them or having their help in the continuing work that we're doing. We also made some customized material to share, and this was produced and spread. So this is, you know, online material for everyone to use. Collaborations, such a big part. We all know that alone is nothing and together is everything. So apart from engaging the public audience and apart from creating the ambassadors, we also addressed politicians, the authorities, businesses, because these can all act on a larger scale. They can be part of the campaign, of course, but hopefully their participation will also lead to important work upstreams. In order so that we heard the EU Parliament talking before. So this is really a big target group for us, and we think they are important, not only because of their possibility to finance the work, but also because they are able to enforcing the law, design products against littering, informing their staff. We will reach target groups that we otherwise won't be able to reach through their channels. So this is really a big part of our campaigning. I added slide on the costs because everyone sits with this question and said, well, how expensive is it and how much work does it take? Well, we put, as I said, we had quite a large budget for us. So around 900,000 euros, and we have put around 2,000 man hours in the campaign. So you see, it's quite a large, it is our largest campaign and our largest efforts in our budget yearly. So could Sweden become even cleaner? And yes, I would say it can. This day, we cleaned Sweden from 400 tons of litter on only one day. And in our investigations or surveys afterwards, 8 out of 10 Swedes say it is really important to have such a day. So this is why we're going to continue the work, and we are happy to be part of the Let's Do It campaign and World Cleanup Day. And we are planning, of course, to do a lot of what's good last year and to add some more ingredients for this year's campaign. Thank you.
Johanna, thank you so much for that. Johanna Ragnartz, the country leader of Let's Do It Sweden and the CEO of Keep Sweden Tidy. I liked your last slide saying there are no free lunches. This is how much it costs. No free lunches. And you know what? Everybody is so glad that you got your PowerPoint working in the end, because I'd offered to sing some ABBA and nobody apparently wanted to hear that. So I don't know. But we do want to hear people's questions. Before we move on to our next speaker, we have time for a question or two. If you would like to ask a question, then simply unmute your microphone. Tell us who you are and where you're asking the question from. We'll leave it open for a minute or so to give people a chance before we move on to the next speaker. So if you'd like to ask a question, unmute your microphone now and give a holler.
You can also mail me afterwards, if you think of questions afterwards, I will be on the website, the Keep Sweden Tidy website.
And Johanna, because your talk is so comprehensive and was so good, it could have cleared up everything. People might not have questions.
I have a question here. What does the cleaning kit include? It's a plastic bag or a few plastic bags and a pair of gloves.
And just for the record, that question came in on the text.
Yeah, I just would say it is a large cost, but it's, since the bags are branded and everyone are so happy to show it, it also gave a really good marketing value.
Yeah, that was one thing I thought. The huge number there, the costs involved, might have been inclined to put some people off. How did you go about raising that money?
Well, as I said, this year we actually had some funding from the government. But otherwise, it's collaboration with businesses, bits and pieces, like everyone, I think.
Yeah, and the government funding, would that have made up the majority of that amount? Or
yeah.
Would you still have? Yeah, okay.
This year it was, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, any final questions before we move on to our next speaker? I can see one in the text there.
It was something about the plastic. Let's see, what was it? Could you read it for me, please? What do we do with the plastic after collections? Well, the participants are urged to sort the litter. But then we also have collaboration with municipalities and pick up places where they can leave the garbage or the litter, and the municipalities will pick it up.
Johanna, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Knowing me, knowing you. Uh-huh. Okay, we're moving on now to our next speaker. Before we head back to China, we still want to make sure that audio is okay with our link to China. So we are going now next to South Africa. Camilo Ramada is the country leader of Let's Do It South Africa. Camilo, are you there? And can you hear me? There he is. How are you, my friend, today? Now we can't hear you. Make sure your microphone is unmuted.
Yes, I'm muted by the host. So thank you for unmuting me.
What part of South Africa are you in?
We're in Johannesburg, based in Johannesburg. Our organization also has a foot in Cape Town. Right now I'm in Johannesburg, and you can see the beautiful trees in the background.
And I like those cool glasses, man. You're looking pretty cool.
Thanks, man. Okay.
So the title of your talk is nice and simple, and we'll hand it over to you. It's simply South Africa. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And thank you everyone and all the people who opened the conference. It's very impressive. And thank you very much to Let's Do It World. We received so much support during the whole campaign and the structures and the systems that are in place. It is just amazing. It's also very, very inspiring to be working in a global group with people from all over the world. We have internal conferences, either for the Africa region or globally. And it's always so incredibly inspiring. And we get a lot of support and ideas and insights from our partners in other countries. So it's an amazing experience to be part of. And obviously with an incredibly important mission. We believe that the World Cleanup Day is not about the day. There's only so much you can clean up in a day, and the impact on it, on the global problem, is maybe not that big, but it's about the awareness building. And everybody who participates in a cleanup goes home with a much bigger awareness of what the magnitude of our problem is, and with a much bigger disposition to change their behaviors and to influence in their environment and to have a positive view on the green transition. It's a really important campaign. The organization that I represent is called GEM, Going the Extra Mile. We have been doing community engagement work in South Africa since 2014. We manage more than 3,000 such events with more than 50,000 participants. And a lot of those events were cleanups. So when we came with the Cleanup World and Let's Do It World, there was at that moment no leader for South Africa for the World Cleanup Day. So that's 3 years ago, and we decided let's try it. Let's try to make it happen. Let's put the World Cleanup Day firmly on the South African calendar that everybody knows that the third Saturday in September is the World Cleanup Day. We have done two campaigns now, and what we know is that we are, as GEM, going there somehow. We're not that strong. We've got also like not any significant budget. So what we did is we teamed up, I think it's about leveraging efforts. So we teamed up with people who have been doing cleanups for decades. We teamed up with the National Plastic Recycling Agency, Plastics SA, who have been involved in cleanups for more than 25 years. We teamed up with many NGOs on the ground and organizations on the ground who do cleanups. And through that, we managed to really aggregate around the World Cleanup Day. Some organizations like me in my own neighborhood, we do cleanups on an ongoing basis. But then on the World Cleanup Day, what we do falls under the banner and the flag of the World Cleanup Day. And by doing that, we have gotten quite a lot of outreach. We were now finally this year also in the national media. And we had we managed also to improve our measurement of impact. And I think I'm very proud to say that last year we had about 60,000 people cleaning up in South Africa, and that was under COVID. We had almost 400,000 garbage bags collected at different sites. We had about 450 cleanups that we know of, because anybody can do something on the day. It's like Valentine's Day. Anybody is free to go on a date on the World Cleanup Day. Anybody's free to go clean up. So we don't know everything that happens, but there's 450 cleanups that happened under our system with more than 60,000 volunteers. And we estimate that there have been around 120 tons of garbage collected. So we're very, very happy. We not happy enough. We want more visibility. We started a circular economy blog last year, which got some visibility, but we really have to strengthen our Facebook, Instagram campaigns for this year. And what we are looking for this year is to team up with groups maybe at the university or somehow to find a volunteer leading team for the whole campaign for this year. And what we have struggled with, so that is something that we're very, very excited about, to have a group of young people running the campaign and making it much bigger, better, and cooler than it is. And the one thing that we have really struggled with and continue to struggle with is funding. We have been lucky that we had volunteers making a video the last 2 years, but we've got no funding for the management or operation or the marketing of the campaign. So we'll continue to look for that. That is definitely one of the main strategies for this year.
Camilo, thank you very much for that. And if we have any questions from the audience, please type it in the chat below. Camilo, keep a look at that chat there. Keep an eye on it, and we might see some killer questions coming in for you. Although that was a pretty comprehensive talk. And I love the background where you are. Are you on the beach?
I'm in a very big garden with lots of various plants and trees.
It looks beautiful. It looks really, really beautiful.
Thanks. Thank you so much. I thought let's get a real background, not the plastic background or a digital background, and let's get something green. Let's remember what we do it for. We do it all for Mother Earth.
Yeah, as you can see, I went for this very beautiful scenic background here. The gray, with the gray over here matching the beige here. So I think you win when it comes to the background.
Thank you very much.
Questions. Can you see that on your screen there, Camilo?
I'm trying to go between all the screens. There are so many screens. But yeah, I see it. Let me scroll down. Let me scroll down.
There's a question. Where did you get those cool sunglasses?
Thank you very much. I can't share those secrets, but I can...
They're from the future. Thank you. Thank you. Through the time travel continuum to get those guys.
I don't like glasses to be too big, so I looked for something smaller.
No, but seriously, have a look there. I think there is a question in the chat. See if you can see something.
I don't see a question. I see lots of comments. Where is the question?
Maybe it's just lots of compliments. We'll come back to you if we have some questions. We're going to move on with our next speaker. And Camilo, thank you so much there in South Africa. Thank you. Big round of applause, everybody, to Camilo there at his cool sunglasses. Now we're going to move on. We're going to head back to China in a moment. We're still working on that because we are going now next. Let's look at my screen here where we're talking to my producers. And yes, we're going to go to Julia next. So Julia Markel is talking to us from Ukraine. Hey, there's Julia. And the best media and social advertising campaign for World Cleanup Day. Now, everybody knows Julia is the queen of social media when it comes to the World Cleanup Day. She always has been. She's there every single time on the World Cleanup Day at all the conferences. She puts her heart and soul into it. First of all, let me ask, how are you?
Thank you so much. I am okay.
You look great. And thank you for gracing.
I'm ready to this year and hard work campaign for Ukraine and for all world. So hello, people, the best people around the world.
So take it away. Tell us, because you are the master at this, engaging people and getting eyeballs at a time when there is so much noise in social media and so many people trying to get others' attention. How do you cut through that noise and how do you make it a success, Julia?
I think online life, it is 5% in real life. So if you use in social media like 5% in your life, you will have very big auditory and users in your page and in your life in internet. So of course it is the best media advertising and PR campaign for yourself, like leaders, and for your campaigns in your country, for your organization, for World Cleanup Day. So Alexandra, can you help me please open my presentation? Yeah, thank you so much. So my name is Julia, I'm from Ukraine, and I am founder member Let's Do It World Movement and leader in Let's Do It Ukraine. Today about the best media and social advertising campaign, not a social network, but social advertising in real life. Let's Do It is the biggest environmental ecological movement in Ukraine. We have many projects and all projects work to World Cleanup Day and for promotions. So next slide, please. Our team is very big. We have 16 national coordinators, 65 volunteers for press center and department of social advertising, 24 regional coordinators, 3,945 local coordinators, more like 10,000 volunteer staff, and of course 99% work for free. Thank you for all our team leaders and volunteers. About result World Cleanup Day in Ukraine this year was 300,000 participants, and we did clean 3,945 locations, and doing this in all regions. And region who have warm now, the best region at World Cleanup Day campaign in Ukraine this last year. So next slide, please. Of course, we have the best position in the world because Ukraine broke the record for the youngest participant in cleanup in the world. Yesenia is a girl from Kharkiv region who has 8 days old at the time of cleanup took first place. So it's the best news was for us. And of course, formats was different. It's collective cleanups, individual, digital, mapping everything for clean planet, for clean Ukraine. We are using hashtags in social media. Let's do it Ukraine, let's do it world, and local Pobachov Prebery. It's like seed, clean it. And we have a special Telegram chat if you want to use it too, because we have all photos around Ukraine here in Telegram chat. All leaders send photos. So here is interesting place. Next, please, slide. School children during the World Cleanup Day, they the best, because 41,000 school children joined us last year and recycle and clean Ukraine. So they have very good result. But I know in Ukraine we have 5 million school children, so we are preparing for all activity for all school children in Ukraine this year. Next, please. Start media campaign and advertising campaign was from VIP Eco Picnic. We invited influencers, superstars, media, did press conference, mini cleanup. Celebrities motivate thousands of Ukrainians to embark of environmental change and join the historical Action World Cleanup Day. Next slide, please. Central location was in Erevan region. So on the day of the event, the national press conference was held at the central location in 21 region and of course in Kyiv in capital. Media report. Here is the best for us. I think after 7 years, when we start, total number of media coverage, 1,107. For us, it's a real record. We have media coverage in online media, in television, in radio, everywhere, in websites. And this number about news, about information. It's not like information about promo. Promo will be to next slide. So here you see numbers, media activity for all our, the biggest project in Ukraine from Let's Do It Ukraine. But of course, the best, it is World Cleanup Day. Next, please. And here we see all screenshots from the top media in Ukraine. It's prime time. It's more 15 million people who look in morning, in the evening, every day. This information from superstars, from influencers, and from politics, from everyone. The best media social advertising campaign. It is media. It's about media, and for World Cleanup in from August to September was 755 media coverage. Next slide, please. Social advertising, it's about indoor and outdoor advertising. It's about video and audio social promo. So total number advertising coverage was more 60,000 times. Total audience of more than 15 million people. Next slide. And of course, you see here, it's billboards, city lights, posters, video boards, TV, radio, and shops, retails, everywhere. Of course, we have partners, and we have special partners, logistic partners, and information partners. Next, please. And feel free to to contact with me. Here are our information and my personal information. I am only glad to see you and help and to work with you. Stay healthy, let's save our planet and do it together. Thank you.
Wow, the crowd is going wild. Julia, thank you so much for that great presentation about social media. Any questions for Julia? If you have a question, put it in the comments below. And for a moment, I will just say, Julia, thank you once again. And I like that wood behind you. Are you in a cabin, a wood cabin?
Sorry, what?
Oh, nothing. Then ignore me. Just, is there a question coming in there at the bottom? I think there is.
Okay, the best in runner.
Can you see the text and the questions there?
No, can you help me, please?
Yes, if you open up the chat, I can see there are people putting some messages in the chat. There's a question here. I can read it to you. When will you start the campaign this year? What material do you generate previous to the event?
Okay. Information campaigns start from March, but media and social advertising and social media advertising before 2 months to start.
2 months before. So that's your lead in, around 2 months.
Yeah.
And what do you generate beforehand? What kind of material?
We have many materials for everything, for many formats, and we have video, audio, we have pictures, and everyone partner who give to us support using that and doing like a special format.
Tanswell in the comments as well says, Julia, I don't have a question. I just want to tell you I'm very inspired.
Thank you so much, Tanswell.
So we'll come back to you again if we have some more questions. But Julia, for the time being, thank you so much. Actually, one last question. Julia, how do you think can Ukraine make 400 participants this year?
I think Ukraine in this year have very big plan. We want more 1 million participants. So Indonesia, are we going?
No pressure, eh? Julia, thank you so much. All the best to Ukraine. Wild dances. Thank you.
I'm just thinking maybe, I don't know, Ukraine and Indonesia can also work together to create a bigger campaign. So I know that Julia, you will maybe soon reach more than 1 million people. Could be maybe Ukraine will lead, you know, like bigger number than Indonesia. It's so excited to see
my dreams. So Indonesia, please help me. Give me know how many people you have in this year, so I will prepare it.
This is how I said that maybe between countries that we can create campaign together. So that's
thank
really
so
good.
Much.
Wow. Love. When you hear that, I think it's worthy of this. All together, everybody. I can't play anymore because we'll get in trouble because of copyright. We're streaming this. But Julia, thank you so much. And thanks for that interjection as well, Agustina. Now, we are over in time, so I'm being told to keep the show on the road. And next, we are heading to Turkey. I think Istanbul. We're going to talk to Cenzig Kasak. And the talk is called Effective Ways to Work with the Ambitious Youth of Turkey. And there he is on my screen now, looking pretty cool. The beard is trimmed. It's ready to go. The hair is sticking up on the top and he's got a virtual background. He's a cool man. Cenzig, over to you, my friend.
Yeah. Hello. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine, but actually I'm not from Istanbul, from Ankara.
Ah, I guess I got it wrong.
Again, same mistake.
Well, over Turkey's a beautiful country. Every way that I can, I'll try to make you love me again. Great song. So with your talk, please inspire us.
Yeah, thank you. And I have a small presentation for you and I will start. Yeah, can everybody see my screen? Yeah,
yes.
Okay. Hello guys, I'm Cengiz Kasak from Turkey and today I'm going to talk with you about the effective ways to work with ambitious youth. And I will just mention about the four topics. We are going to talk about 2021 youth participation and social media strategy. And lastly, we are going to conclude my speech shortly. I don't want to take your time for so long, so I just would like to start slightly. So the first, I think we need to talk about 2021 because it's really hard year for all of us. The whole world affected by COVID-19, and we see the quarantine procedure for the COVID-19. But also in Turkey, it's quite hard for us because during the summer we have the forest fires all over the Turkey, and also we have the earthquakes, which is really the damage our society for a long time during this summer. So these all hazards, I think, make us being the more stronger because we need to do something to work more efficient and we need to give the hopes to the people. That's why we mainly working on the mobilizing youth in our event, in our activities, and also we are really keen to working with the all NGOs that inspire in Turkey. I will be mentioned about how many NGOs that we work this year, and also the key driver for our 2021 is back to the municipalities because they are the main part of our success. And lastly, I think I need to talk about the social media campaigns that we do this year. So the first of all, I'd like to just give a brief number about the Turkey. It was about 81 cities and we organized the cleanup events for each cities. And totally we organized 272 cleanup events, which was in 2019, it was 114. And this year it was 272. And I hope next year we will be reached 500 cleanup events different point during the World Cleanup Day. This year, we make with to over 30,000 heroes, volunteers all over the Turkey from different age, but generally it was organized by the youth. So during this year, we have the cigarette campaign, we have the cleanup events, and also we have the social activities for our network, for increasing the number of participants in our network. We do cleanup in everywhere. We do cleanup in the mountains, in the entire city roads, underwater, and also we do in the forests, lakes, beaches, and also prominent areas, cities, camping areas, and so on. But these all things, it just can happen by the power of the cooperation, because if we didn't cooperate with the organization, NGOs, or student clubs, we couldn't achieve any of these success. That's why the number of the organization that we worked during this year, it was reached over the 200. We worked with this 87 different NGOs during this year because every city we choose one NGO that we can work. And also we work with 65 student clubs and schools to join the cleanup events. And also we work for 46 different companies who can support us for our needs for cleaning movements. And also we work with the government institutions, three of them, especially the Ministry of the Youth and Youth and Sport is the biggest actor that took place during the World Cleanup Day, because thanks to them we organized the 81 cities cleanups in last year. And also the best effective way is, I think, it's our social media, because our social media both can inspire the youth and can be attractive for the youth. And also it's made to be good for our to knowing by the people. The first that we started in the January, we analyzed our social media, the analyzing of social media in Turkey, what's the trends in Turkey, how the people use the social media and so on. And during this time, we have just 2,000 followers. And the next step, we're evaluating our own page. Who is our target group? What can we do and how we can increase our number for the our number of the followers? And when we evaluate this one in March, we are approximately close to 5,000 followers. And then we starting to creating different content which is informative and which is useful for the people, that can share with their friends. They can they can learn something from our social media, and it makes to our social media increased about the 10,000. And lastly, we use our social media as a being friendly, because instead of being the just an association page, we use like it's our own social media page, and we're trying to be used as friendly language to all of the people who text us. I just would like to tell the story about here with our social media campaigns, because we really got several messages from the people every day. And one day a just woman sent us a message, and she mentioned that normally when I walked outside to have a picnic with my girl, when I see the trash outside of the in the forest, I just blame the people and just walk around it. But when I started follow you, I see that I can do something. And today I just take my package and I collect all trash. This is what's your effect to us. This is exactly what she sent us, and we see how it's being effective. And in the September, during the World Cleanup Day, we reached over the 17,000 volunteers, and currently it was over the 15,000 volunteers in our social media. So these social media campaigns actually being the eye catching for the all youth, and youth became starting to give the importance to this movement more in Turkey. And in the morning of the World Cleanup Day, we just shared this picture, which is in the left side, and it was rewritten that today we are going to clean the Turkey. And really, we did it. We did this one. We cleaned all over to Turkey in the 81 cities, 272 different locations, which is over the 30,000 youth. And end of my speech, instead of saying thank you to listening, I just would like to thank you to everyone, because the success of this beautiful network is achieved through the people who spend their time and take responsibility in this action. And personally, I took this responsibility for more than 4 years, and I believe that I took this responsibility till we collect the last garbage on the earth. Thank you for listening, and thank you for being here.
Our pleasure for listening. And Chenzik, thank you so much for your passionate presentation and your beautiful slides as well. We'll leave it open for a minute. If anyone would like to ask a question, please put it in the comments. And actually, one is just after coming in, quite a long question. I don't know if you can see it there, if you've access to the chat.
Yeah, I can see.
Read out that question there and you see if you have an answer.
Yeah, it was about the school. I can just give the brief question about how we cooperate with school. In Turkey, each school can join the volunteer works by their own decide. And this in this case, the teachers who work in the school or the senior who conduct the school is very important, because in Turkey, most of them are open who we talked, and they accept to join with their students. That makes important step for us. I don't know in the Indonesia how they can work, but in Turkey, the school can decide it by themselves.
Perfect. Thank you very much for that, Bintang. And thank you very much, Chenzig, as well. Now, someone is saying your video column, has your video gone off? Let's have a little look here. Maybe it did go off. Now, is it still off? That's strange, isn't it? My video has gone off. And now it's back again. It's on this laptop. We will fix it in a moment. But now we are going to try and go back to China. Look, I'm down here now, everybody. I was up there, but now I'm down here. Let's check back in with Juan in China. Juan, are you there? Have you fixed your technical difficulties? And can we get the story from China? Yes, we can hear you now, Juan. Over to you.
Okay. Finally. Yeah, thank you for the tech team to support just now. Get the little issue of the audio, but now it's all good. And just want to say I'm so happy to see everyone. Good to see all the faces I know and some new faces I can see. And it will be a lovely night or afternoon everywhere around the world. Yeah, so I will start sharing my screen. Okay, can everyone see it? Yes, it's working?
Yes, confirmed. We can see it, Juan.
Okay, cool. Okay, I am NY from Pick Up China. We are the leading team of World Clean Up Day in China. And the World Clean Up Day is, since 2018, our most important and most mainly project in our NGO. So we want to share some review from what we do since 2018. And we can see the total number of participants are rising to 760K for the over 4 years in total. And we cleaned almost more than 1,500 tons of trash, and then 630,000 cigarette butts and a lot of plastic bottles too. And then for the 2021, we have over 210,000 participants have joined the cleanup day in that day. And then we have over 176 cities joined in the same day and then doing cleanup at the same time. And then today, I think the main topic I want to share is our new strategy. Since 2020, we started to have this city leaders to work strategy around China. We want to promote and motivate more power from each city to have the leader have more motivation and then to have more inspirational stories coming out during World Cleanup Day. And we can see this is the top 10 cities who have reached a lot of participants joining in this year. And then today I will share two stories I feel really touching and inspiring to everyone. The first one is Wuhan. I think maybe you guys are familiar with this city's name because that's the first city started from the suffering from the COVID pandemic. And then this team, this leading team of World Cleanup Day in Wuhan is very special because they are not volunteers. They are just normal citizens before 2020, but they gathered because the COVID, they were volunteers for the hospitals, for the, helping the people to transportations and then to get help to support them, everyone during the really hard time. So after a few months, the pandemic situation is getting better, but this team of volunteers are still wanting to do more meaningful things to the world. So they saw our post about World Cleanup Day. And then they thought turning to supporting environment could be another amazing thing to do for the earth. So they contacted us and came to the Leaders Academy last year. And then they since then, they committed to joining World Cleanup Day. And then they did really good job last year already, have motivated over 10,000 people in that city. And this year they have growth, and then they've been more professional, and then they connected to more people, more government, local governments, more companies. So this year they have become the number one city who reached 250,000 participants this year, the top one city in China. And then they are the one team who are became officially NGO. They registered to officially NGO because of World Cleanup Day. So I think it's a very, very touching story, even to our team. And then we see their growth, and we see how they are committed to doing more work, and then to for the clean world. And then the second city I wanted to introduce is also one of my, it's my hometown. So I think it's a very nice way to say it, because this team is also very special. The leader who also joined, the first time joined World Cleanup Day last year since 2020, and he is only a high school student, but he saw our message too, and then he came to the Leaders Academy. Then he has came, he since then he came back to his hometown and talked to the school, talked to the city, city's educational bureau. So he motivated over 2,000 participants in his city. And this year he became a university student, he came to a bigger city, and then he still wanted to promote working update in his school and into many, many other universities. So he's trying really hard to reach to the province educational bureau, and he got successful. And then he this year he motivated over 6,000 students in the city and in some other city around to do working update. So these two stories, we feel it's very interesting, because they are or some team leader who are have no experience for doing cleanup, or they have no experience even knowing World Cleanup Day, but they feel it's really meaningful for themselves to do, and also it's really give them more, make them for feeling more powerful and for more meaningful for the environment. So they have committed to do it since 2 years, and then they said they will keep doing it for many, many years. And then also we have a few partners who are working with us and then supporting each other for long term. One is the Ocean Network, and then the River Cleanup Network in China. And this year we have also have a very new special network is a Buddhism network, Ciji. They are also from Taiwan. I think they are very powerful and community in Taiwan. And this year, they first time joined World Cleanup Day in China, in the mainland. And then they motivated 10 cities, over 5,000 participants to join the cleanup in many, many different places. And then we also have some very good corporate partners who are working with us. I think one, it's our global partner too, is Decathlon. They have joined the China Cleanup Day for 4 years. Yeah, since the first year. And then every time they will let all the shops to the shop leaders to decide if they wanted to join World Cleanup Day. And then this year they have 44 cities shop joining, and they reached a big, good number too. And then we have a running app who is also giving us a lot of our participant numbers every year. And then this year they did a very special campaign. It's called 9.19 kilometer plugging running. So because of pandemic, we know not so many people can go out and do group running all the time. So they use this campaign, they can reach a lot of solo runners to do blogging on the World Cleanup Day. And then the total route who ran together is over 640,000 kilometers. So it's a very, very long route who people did clean up while running. And then as our China's tradition, we also have created a campaign every year. So this year we did a campaign called Trash Calling, who is also, we collaborated with a creative studio who are have two very creative and inspirational creative person from Shanghai and Paris. So they created this little very cute logo of Trash Calling to us, and also made two videos and posters design. And I want to show you the, so we have this campaign as three phases. The first phase is we released a teaser video in July, and I can show you this video here. Okay, 1 second. Okay, I hope we can see this smoothly.
我们就开始启动一个吗？我们一起，我们一起，我们一起，我们一起。
Okay, so it's quite artistic, this video. So they use 3D design, and they created this a little bit a voice, a trash calling voice from the space, and then showing a lot of plastic floating in a spacey area, and then to show us we should notice the plastic problem, and then we should start acting, and then we should go out and doing something. And then we have also some celebrity ambassadors who are became the caller of this year. They are showing the picture of they are listening, they heard the trash calling, and then they wanted to let more people to start hearing the, to get the message, to start to act. And then the third phase, we have another video who is, who became the main campaign material. So this,
据统计，每年有约1300万吨的塑料垃圾被倒进大海。人类生产的垃圾被填埋到天空上，被倾倒山里，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒山里，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒山里，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒山里，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒山里，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾倒陆地，被倾
我听见了。
Okay, so this is our main video of the campaign. And you can, as you can see, we showed a lot of people heard that message and then they awaken and then they wanted to start act to come out and then join Clean Up Day, go out to do the pickup. And then we use this message as the starting point to show on a lot of different platforms in China, as the main platform Weibo and then WeChat. And then we showed this video on a lot of other online video platform as TikTok, Bilibili, or other main platform in China, to let more people to see it. And then maybe they hear the voice and then they see how people are awakened by the message, and then they also can start joining us. And then we get a lot of this video got a lot of good response, and then our view of World Cleanup Day has reached 120 million views, and then over 200,000 discussions on the biggest social media platform Weibo. And then we also have ads on metro station, and then on taxi, on the back of the taxi. And then we have a lot of national and local press reports before the World Cleanup Day, also after the World Cleanup Day, to show how much trash we collected and how active people are. And of course, every year we have a lot of partners to support us, to even for sponsoring us or to motivate from their community, have more people to joining or to support us on different resources as ads or their resources, manpowers. Yeah, so this is my presentation. Thank you.
Juan, thank you so much. That was a wonderful presentation. And if anyone has a question for Juan, please put it in the comments and I will see it here and she will see it there in China. And I know that people specifically were touched by the story of people going out in Wuhan after everything that happened and cleaning up. People are saying so impressive. Yeah, incredibly inspiring. Juan, just a question for me. Was it difficult for the people of Wuhan to be inspired and be encouraged and get together for a cause like World Cleanup Day after what had happened with the coronavirus? And now the name Wuhan is known all over the world, kind of in a negative light. Was it difficult to get people worked up for a cause like this, a good cause?
I think at the beginning, people are hesitant to go out. But after, I think also this city has suffered from such a tragic event. And but by that event, there are so many volunteers coming out and everyone wanted to do something to support their city, to support their community. And I think by this, there are so many people feel they can do so much more above their normal daily life. So after all, it became a very interesting cases in our community, because we realized by that team, how many people they motivated and then how supportive their local governments is. I think it's a very good result in the end.
A question in here, how do you deal with the collected garbage? What happens to it?
So in China now, most cities have a waste sort management. So we will send the recyclables to the recycling center, and then the others we will send to the waste bureau, to for the local waste station. But it is still a little problem when we do cleanups in countryside and in the rural area. We still encourage people to bring them to somewhere has the proper management, waste management station.
That is fantastic. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Juan, everybody. Yay. It was well worth the wait. I know we had some technical issues, but your presentation, like last year, just really outstanding. And the effort that you go to with the advertising, with the videos, with the social media, you guys really go above and beyond. So thank you so much, Juan. Well done. And I like the green hair.
Thank you.
It is, it's cool. It's rocking. Thank you. Okay, next we're going from China to Cameroon. And we're saying hello to Cameroon. And there for us, we are going to speak to Mrs. Memunata. Miss Memunata. Can Cameroon hear me? Let's wait and see Cameroon pop up on the
hello.
Screen.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, Colm. Hi, hi everyone. Happy to meet you.
We are very happy to hear your talk because the title of it is Nature is Gold and God. So please, in your own time, take it away.
Thank you very much, Colm. Thank you. Colm, I don't know, can someone share my presentation? I don't know if I'll be able to do that.
Yes, and if you could turn on your camera, that would be fantastic because at the moment we can just see your name. So if you were able to turn on your camera, because if we don't, we can't see,
I won't be able to use my camera because when I put on the camera, the network will be disturbing.
Oh, the network will be disturbing.
Will I be able to do?
I see.
So if I can do it without the camera, if it's possible, is that okay?
Yeah, let's try then, and we'll see if we can get your presentation up on the screen so that we can hear your voice over the presentation. Because the problem is, if we don't have your camera or presentation, they'll have to look at me while you're talking, and nobody wants that. You know, people that will put people off their dinners, they won't be able to sleep.
Okay, let me try.
Now, I've been told by our technical staff that the presentation is filed in the drive. And I think that means that they're working on it. They're going to get it up. How's everything in Cameroon today while we wait?
Everything is okay. We are grateful. At least there is life and there is hope. So every other thing can wait.
Hope is good. What time is it in Cameroon?
Yeah. Right now we have close to 4 p.m. That's all.
4 p.m. Okay. Well, I'm in Rome in Italy and it's 5 p.m. Nearly.
Oh, close to 5 p.m. Sorry, close to 5. That's 7 minutes to 5.
So, me too! We're in the same time zone.
Ah, seriously?
Seriously? So we must be on the same line. Rome and Italy and Cameroon. And the funny thing is, I live right next door to the... I'm not just talking, I'm waiting for the presentation to pop up on screen. So the technical guys can let me know here when they have it up so I can stop waffling.
Okay.
I live next door to the Vatican, so Pope Francis is my neighbor. He's watching this
all
conference
right,
next
I can
door.
Share something. What? Wow, that's interesting.
Now, okay, I'll tell you what, Miss Cameron.
Okay, can I share this one while waiting?
Yeah, if you can try and share it, we will do that. But I think if we don't get it in the next 60 seconds, we'll come back to you because our technical team are working on it. Now, I think.
Okay, I share this.
You shared it. Now, we are still looking at your name. Oh, something is happening.
Can you see?
Something is happening. Let's put... Oh, here we go. We can see your presentation on the screen now.
Okay.
We can see it.
Yeah! So we just go with this one. Yeah! Because I can't access the other one. I'm using my...
So if you want to make that full screen...
Hello?
Yes, if you... if you want to make it full screen and you can talk us through your presentation.
Full screen.
Full screen, I think so, yes.
Okay.
And I know you have a TV on in the background, so maybe if you could be nice and close to the microphone, nice and loud.
Oh, no, it's okay, yeah.
We're getting there, everybody, we're getting there.
I'm trying to see how to share full screen.
While we wait for it to go full screen, I'll play some music here.
I can't do that. Hello?
Yes. Now, I think something is happening here. We probably will have to move on in just a second. If we can't get it full screen, the presentation, we're not seeing it. I'm just seeing myself. Cameroon, we will come back to you in a second. And thank you for your patience, everybody. This is a live conference, and this is what happens. I think that's the perfect music for just now. Okay, let's see. Have we got Singapore in the house? We might head to Singapore next. And somebody's Gmail is on the screen now. I think this is the most appropriate music I could find for right now.
Okay, hello?
Okay, we'll skip next to Singapore or Kazakhstan. Which one is in the house? Do we have Kazakhstan or Singapore? Make yourselves known if you're here. Okay, if we don't have
Please
Kazakhstan...
Please come back to me.
Yes, we'll come back to you in Cameroon.
Okay.
So we'll try and fix the technical gremlins. I know your internet is not that strong. We'll try and get that fixed.
Well, maybe we can go to get Singapore first, I think.
Yes, or Singapore
well,
later.
Wait. Yes, Yoko is here, ready for the games.
Oh, Yoko. Okay, Yoko, if you can hear me. Great to see you, Agustina,
as always. Can you hear me now?
There you are.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for the wait.
You.
Yeah, thank you so much. I couldn't unmute myself just now. So sorry for the wait. Yes,
hey,
I'm
Yoko. Yoko, look behind you. It's your biggest fan.
Yes. Yes, it's my biggest fan. It's really hot in Singapore, actually.
Okay. Well, you know what? It's great to see you, and we're glad that you've got your big fan there and you're nice and cool. And I believe you're going to play some games with us.
Yes, that's right. Okay, so we will be logging into Kahoot today. Yes, our favorite Kahoot. It's almost like a yearly affair now. Okay, so everyone, please log into kahoot.it. That's kahoot.it. And then please key in the game pin 5906008. Okay, 5906008. Okay, please key in the name that you've logged into Zoom with. And I'll be waiting. Everyone okay?
So this is Kahoot, K-A-H-O-O-T dot I-T, Kahoot dot I-T.
Okay, we see Chris and Hisham. Right. Everyone's coming in. Okay, I'll give it around 30 seconds before we begin.
Can you give us the number again?
590, that is 5906008.
5906008.
6008. That's right. Okay, we've got 18 participants. Come on. Is everyone okay? Yes, hi. Okay, great. You're in. Oh, more and more people are coming in. Okay. Looking good. Okay, we've got 31, 32. Let's go. Yeah, I'll give it a few
more. Everybody, go to kahoot.it and put in the code. Give them the code one more time.
5906008. You can also scan the QR code at site if you need help. Wow, okay, everyone's coming in soon. 40?
That's it, we're gonna play a game. Everybody get inside Kahoot and we'll have a Kahoot and good time.
Okay, shall I begin soon? 43, okay, maybe I'll give it around 10 more seconds. Everyone okay? If anyone needs more time, please feel free to type it in the chat.
How about we do a 20 second countdown? Will we do that?
Okay.
20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Kahoot time!
Yay, let's start. Okay, so before we begin, this will be a quiz about the world trivia. So for the top two winners of this game, each of you will have a tree planted in your name in Indonesia. Yay! So let's try our best to win so that we can have a tree planted in your name too. Okay, without further ado, let's begin. Okay, first question. Ukraine is the world's largest producer of socks, cotton, almonds, or sunflower seeds? Make a guess. One more second. Okay, the correct answer is sunflower seeds. Okay, let's look at the scoreboard. And we have Esil, I'm so sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name, as the top scorer for now. And this is because Ukraine has vast tracts of land dedicated to the growth of sunflower seeds. And it's estimated that the total size of Ukraine's sunflower farmlands could cover the entire territory of Slovenia. Yay, thank you so much. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Where did ice cream originate from? Is it Italy? Is it USA, China, or Turkey? Give it your best shot. 5 more seconds. Two, one. Okay, any answer is China. Most of us guess Italy, probably because of the gelato or something. But the answer is China. Okay, let's look at the scoreboard again. Oh, the tables have turned. Arno is at top now. Let's look at the answer, China. An ice cream-like food was first eaten in China in 618 to 697 AD. And it was King Tang who actually started to make this dish with his 94 ice men. Let's look at the next question. Kyrgyzstan has the world's largest horse, walnut forest, apple plantation, or lake? 10 more seconds. Come on, put in your responses. 3, 2, 1. And the answer is walnut forest. Yay! Most of us got it correct. Yay! That's great. Walnut forest. Yes. Let's look at the scoreboard again. Oh, Arno remains at the top. The first three players have changed. Okay. Don't worry, there are still many more questions to go. Okay, walnut forest. The Aslan Bob woodland is the largest walnut grove on Earth. However, due to climate change and soil erosion from overgrazing, the trees are actually being damaged. So let's look at the next question. How much of Sweden is covered in forest? 57%, 36%, 28%, 70%. I think this is quite a tough one. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, let's look at the answer. It's 70%. Wow. I think not bad. Okay, you're getting it. Oh, Arno remains at the top. Wow. Okay, let's look at the answer. More than 70% of Sweden's landscape is covered by forests. And in less than 100 years, Sweden's forest assets have actually doubled. So how has Sweden managed to grow its timber industry even though it has is so covered in forests? The simple answer is that Sweden grows more trees than it chops down. All right. Hope you're doing well. Everyone okay? Next one, which is false about Germany? Is it there are highways with no speed limit? 1/3 of Germany is covered in forests and woodlands. Germany has more zoos than any other country, over 400 of them. Or in the state of Bavaria, beer is actually considered a food. Okay, I see the answers coming in. And the answer is, in the state of Bavaria, beer is actually considered a food. But this is actually a trick question, and I'll reveal why later on. Okay, Arno still remains as top. And the fact is true, but the state is wrong. It's actually Bavaria, not Bavarian. I hope we got it. Okay, let's look at the next question. Where was Santa Claus, St. Nicholas, born in? Italy, Greece, Korea, or Turkey? I see the responses coming in much faster this time. Okay, we have 5 more seconds to do this. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And St. Nicholas was born in Turkey. I know many of us thought from Greece, but Turkey is the answer. Let's look at the scoreboard again. Arno is on fire. And then we have Holger and Humberto, second and third positions. Okay, there's still time to catch up. Don't worry. All right, let's look at the answer. Turkey. St. Nicholas was an early Christian bishop. Because of the many miracles attributed to his prayers, he's also known as Nicholas the Wonder Worker. And his legendary habit of secret gift giving gave rise to the tradition of Santa Claus, St. Nick. All right, let's look at the next question. Cameroon has the world's rarest shark. Human, strawberry, ape. And the answer is ape. Okay, let's look at the scoreboard again. Arno is on top and the positions haven't changed. All right, and yes, it's ape. And that is the cross river gorilla, but it's a critically endangered subspecies of the western gorilla. And it lives in a few of the forests in Cameroon. And this ape was unknown to science till the early 20th century. Now, true or false question. In the USA, there's an entire palace made out of corn. Is it true or is it false? 3, 2, 1. And the answer is true. It's true. Okay, I'll show you a picture of it. Okay, Arno is still on top. Okay, let's take a look at the picture. Yes, it is made of corn. It is called the Corn Palace. It's a multi-purpose arena or facility located in Michelle, South Dakota, United States. And the building is decorated with crop art. And these murals, as you can see, covering the building are made of corn or other grains. You can also feel free to Google the Corn Palace so you can see more epic pictures of it. Next. Please type in your answer. South Africa boasts how many percent of the world's bird, fish, and plant species? Go ahead and type in a number. 10, 9, 8, 7. You can type in anything as long as you're fast. And the answer is, oh, we have many answers. Many different answers from all of you. But the correct answer is 10. Oh, one of you got it correct. Wow, that is amazing. One of you got 10% correct. Yes, that's right. 10%.
Cheating, cheating.
Did someone Google this? All right. Arno, Holger, and Chris. All right. Let's look at the answer. From adverts to zebras, South Africa is full of wildlife. The country takes up Although the country only takes up about 1% of the Earth's land surface, it's home to almost 10% of the world's known bird, fish, and plant species. All right, good job, everyone. All right, and this question is going to be quite a tough one, but let's try our best. Arrange the provinces in Indonesia according to the smallest to largest population. I think for the Indonesians, it's no problem. So we have Riau Islands, North Kalimantan, Papua, as well as West Java. We have 6 more seconds. Let's try our best. Rearrange them according to smallest to largest population. And the answer is North Kalimantan as the smallest. I think Agustina can explain this too. North Kalimantan smallest, Riau Islands, Papua, West Java. Yes. Yeah, so only 11% of us got it correct, probably the Indonesians. All right, and that was the last question. So let's take a look at the results. In third place, we have Chris. And in the first two positions, we have a tree planted your name, Holger, as well as who is in the top position? Congratulations. Okay, could you please raise your hand and wave? So we can see who you are, Arno and Holger, where are you? Congratulations, we're so happy for you. Congratulations on having a Holger tree and an Arno tree. Yay! Thank you so much for having me. And I'll pass my time back to the host. Thank you.
Now I've been unmuted. Thank you so much for that great game. And you know what? It's a little bit sad because when I looked at the leaderboard, I think I was like down near the bottom. I think there must have been something wrong with the game. What happened there? Yoko, explain that to me. What went wrong there? I'm obviously a very smart guy, so.
I'm glad we enjoyed ourselves though.
Did you come up difficult. With all the questions? Did you do all that yourself?
I Googled them.
You Googled them? Well, I think some people were Googling the answers because some people were very good. But well done to everyone who took part. And we'll keep on moving. Thank you so much.
Thank you
and,
so much.
And next, we are going from Singapore. And Yoko, once again, round of applause for Yoko, everyone. That was fantastic. Well Thank done. You. Good game. And it was a lot of fun with her biggest fan behind her. Next, we are going to Kyrgyzstan. And Aijan is in Kyrgyzstan, and she is going to talk to us now. She is the country leader of Let's Do It Kyrgyzstan, and the presentation is simply called Kyrgyzstan OK. So it is now over to you, Aijan.
Can you hear me, guys?
We can hear you loud and clear.
Oh, great. It's like what an inspirational day today. So many beautiful stories. And I'm like thinking, oh, I should have put this on my on my presentation. Let me see. Can you see my presentation? I'll just do it this way.
Yeah, but if you give it try it again there. We like your bookshelf behind you. Looks beautiful.
Oh, thank you. So let me, if you give me 1 second, everything is ready. So can you see me now, my presentation? Is it on your screen?
Not yet. We can still see you. And now you've run away. Bye. She's come back. Come back. It's not that bad.
I asked my guys to help me, my children, and they've been waiting and listening for the cleanup campaign all over the world for the last 2 hours. Не могут меня увидеть, пожалуйста.
Here come your IT department.
We tried several times.
AKA
okay, can
children.
You see my presentation now? One,
now,
two, three.
In case it's just me, if anyone else can see, yes, now we are seeing it happening and we it see your presentation. Down. Fantastic.
So the presentation actually, we have a name, it's called Wind of Change. And of course, we are very happy to be leaders in the percentage wise. And we cannot compare our small country with 6 million people, of course, to Indonesia. And I was just, you know, looking at our wonderful partners and saying, Agustina, you are really superstar. You know, looking at you, you're inspiring all becoming a Hollywood star, a Bollywood star together. I want to share experience which Kyrgyzstan did this time. We try our best to make changes. And I understand like in China, in Singapore or other countries, there is a lot of governmental changes in terms of waste. With us, we are doing more through civil changes, through business. Now we have an organization for working with the plastic. It's called WasteNet. We are doing a project with them together. It's collaborating business to be creative when they recycle. We put them in one campaign. This is how all, you know, the thing started. Ecodemy, it's called, it means eco breeze. Yes, let's make eco air, clean country. And we did a lot of cleanups, more than 220 activities in the country, more than 600 locations cleaned this year, more than 300,000 volunteers involved in our campaigns, and 4,910 tons of waste was collected. And as you know, we're very proud that our president participated in 2018. And I think it was a big help to all volunteers of Kyrgyzstan, because when president comes and cleans the country, it means that we are acknowledging the problem and we know how to solve it. And of course, as you see, there is more than 5,427 organizations participated. And as you see, almost 8,000 tons of garbage was collected. What I wanted to say that we are keep doing our active work. Each year we have more and more organizations involved. But unfortunately, because of COVID, the number of participants be dropped, because we didn't ask this time, we didn't even involve our schools, kindergartens, and all children facilities. We didn't involve them in our campaign this year, because we think, you know, because of COVID, we are still trying to keep safe our schools and hospitals. And this time we also had, as you see, a rather smaller number, but worldwide we did our percentage, and we are happy that Let's Do It World, our beautiful Heidi and her team being so helpful. And when today I saw Heidi in her first greetings, I thought, who else could connect so many countries in such an elegant and positive way? It was such an honor and joy to work with Let's Do It team. We've been learning each year. We're trying to make our campaign more effective. And as you see, there is a lot of, this is our actually ministry, the cabinet of ministers participating in our cleanups. As I told you, so we due to permanent development of academia foundation, we do have a lot of campaigns, and now we are helping the association of recycling companies to make their own board to influence on our government to make special laws to help to recycling companies. We have it like added cost value to the producers of plastic, or those who bring and make trading with the waste that we are dealing. And it's already the cabinet of ministers put in their campaign, one of the like five laws that will be helping to recycling companies to make a better this world. As you see, this is the part of cleanup challenges that we are doing. We have a team called the Hour of Cleanliness. So it's the volunteers who are cleaning each Saturday in each region of the country. They're making cleanups no matter what. So we are not stopping only on World Cleanup Day. We are doing our cleanups every Saturday. And then at the end of this 1 hour cleanup, we pray and pray for the better world, for the cleaner world. And we are giving the with this challenge to different commercial organizations. So they're doing their team buildings as well. We are trying our best to make educational program with our Minister of Foreign Affairs. We are going and making volunteer talks, inviting kids to participate in our cleanup campaigns. And it's very inspirational how kids see our country and what they want to do with the world. And I think if we do it with the small kids, we have a better future with the ready volunteers. This time, of course, we are working with rural communities. We have our WhatsApp groups where we unite people. We have leaders of these groups who are helping to build on their cleanup communities. And what was different in this campaign, this was the billboards, for example, with this mobile company. They said, let's keep city clean, informational clean as well, not putting a lot of information. We are all we say digital detox, like we did last year with digital cleanup, and this time we did advertising cleanup. So the billboards of city were just white and saying, "Let's have clean world." And as you see on another screen, for example, the satellite company were sharing their boxes for cleanup campaign to all their partners and their clients. So we had a huge campaign and people are getting more creative. And this time we have one of our biggest partners, it's the Mir Bank. They are having their boards, it's more than 30 boards all over capital, and in their in the region they have all like 20, 100 and 200 boards. So we are putting the cleanup campaign starting 1 month prior our events. And as you see, this is a part of our waste management team. So we are trying to, you know, put it together, the plastic and taking out the glasses. What I can say, I want to thank all team. It's very inspirational to see your wonderful presentations. I want to say for me personally, let's do it. I think it's changing not only my life, it's changing life of whole world. But personally, I want to say thank you to Heidi and to this motivational training that she's doing. You know, we are calling, writing to each other. And maybe last year when we've been speaking with the mayor of Tallinn, was a great mayor. And then he said that he has a background from Kazakhstan. Who would know that after 1 year I would be working for municipality myself? And I think it's also achievement that a volunteer became a vice mayor of city, also because of cleaning campaign. So I think this is like another added value to our team leaders, that it's a campaign where we are growing as a professionals, we are growing as a community leaders. And then, of course, it helps all over the world to keep our world safe. And I think so far, I would be very happy to be in touch with all of the presenters. And if it's possible to get your beautiful presentations that we can share it with our teams. Thank you.
Well done. Thank you very much for that beautiful and very informative presentation there all the way from Kurdistan. And thank you very much, Aljan. Am I pronouncing it right? Ajan? Ajan?
Yeah, I means moon, Jan means spirit. So it's the moon spirit. Ajan. You did it great. Colm.
Wow. The moon spirit. That is the amazing. The moon spirit. The moon spirit. That is incredible. You've left me speechless. Ajan, thank you so much. And a big kiss, mwah, back at
to
the moon.
To all of the team of World Cleanup, we love you.
From the moon spirit. That is wonderful. Thank you so much. And thank you to your kids as well, also who double as your IT department. Thank you so much. Yeah, and we are going from the moon spirit of Kurdistan to the sun spirit of Germany. And we're saying Guten Tag to, to Holger Holland. Holger, since we now know what her name means, what does Holger Holland, is there a special meaning to your name?
Yes, I come from Holland.
Oh, you're in Holland, but hang on a second. So you're living in Germany, but from Holland?
Yes, but not me, but in the past, some older people went from there to Germany. So,
can I, first of all, Holger, it looks like you're presenting a late night TV talk show with that set. It looks great. Who's it's your perfect. First guest?
Yes, thanks for the invitation, Halt. Yes, and thanks for the tree. So we can now plant the tree together with Arno and Indonesia. Happy to do that. Yes,
it looks great. That you look fantastic there with your screen and your branding and everything. I know that you were hosting in a previous year and everything went so well. So it's great to have you back. And today you were talking about the key to reaching 5% target, your 5% target, municipalities and the youth. So tell us how you did it, what the key was. And it's over to the late night talk show of Germany, the hottest show in town with your host, Holger Holland. Yay! We love Holger!
Welcome in Berlin. The TV tower is around about 500 meters on the left side. So maybe this is the reason why the picture is so sharp. I hope that. Okay, I will share my screen and then hope the presentation will start. You see my screen?
Yes, we see it perfectly.
Perfect, yes. Okay, yes, I'm Holger Holland. I'm the president of Let's Do It Germany and also, yeah, founding member of the Let's Do It World NGO. And I want to talk today about the key to achieving our 5% goal and which role municipalities and the youth are playing in that role. So thanks for the invitation. And what is the agenda of my hopefully short speech? I know I have 10 minutes. It's more than 10 minutes, but I will give meanwhile of the presentation some hints for the next days for the program slots where we can go deeper in the talk about all these parts. So I will talk about the actual situation in Germany, the supposed situation in Germany, why municipalities and schools are so important to activate, and how to activate municipalities and how to activate schools. In Germany, since 2018, we are doubling the number of participants every year. Last year, we had 189,000 participants, and to compare, in 2018, we had 20,000 participants. Last year, we also grow up to go in, to go out on the cleanup day in more than 800 municipalities. And we, organized or started in Germany more than 3,200 cleanups. And you'll see on the trend, we are on a good way. And this is the one hand. But what we also do in Germany, and this is one of the keys or of the solutions, we look also in the supposed situation, we look also in the future. So our goal for this year is to activate 400,000 to 1 million participants. I hear in the last presentations, also Indonesia and also Ukraine is on the track or over the track. So maybe we can also go together in this topic, Ukraine, Indonesia, and Germany, to reach this real hardcore target. And 7,500 cleanups are the goal in more than 1,200 municipalities in Germany. And what we also do in Germany, this is a kind of our strategy. We look also in the future and when is the target of 5%, when is it possible? And in the moment, it looks that we can reach the 5% goal in 2025. And in Germany, that's 4 million participants and more than 50,000 cleanups in more than 10,000 municipalities, but we are on track. Why? The question is why municipalities and schools are so important. We have found out in the last years a correlation between municipalities, schools, and the cleanups. And if we look deeper in this topic, then we have in Germany more than 8 million school kids. This is 10.5% of the population. Situated in more than 32,000 schools. This is on the one hand, what is on the youth, on the school level. And on the other hand, we have 11,000 municipalities in an umbrella organization. It's called Deutscher Städte- und Gemeindebund, real pronunciation of German. But in this organization, they are more than 50 million citizens of Germany. Yeah. In this organization are organized, and this is 62.5% of the German population. And this is one of the keys, this is the second most important key. It's much easier, I will go later deeper in this topic, but it's much easier to talk with or to communicate with 11,000 municipalities or with 30,000 schools than with millions of volunteers and citizens. And that's the point. We go deeper. How is this possible? And what we did in the last year, especially last year, first step, we activate ambassadors and patrons. We hear it also in other best practice cases from the other top leaders earlier today. But this is one of the most important keys, activate ambassadors and patrons, because those people help to create trust and also media reach. It's a real deep topic. I have not enough time to discuss this deeply enough. But if you want to learn more about this part, we have a workshop, Greenwash or Partnership, How to Make a Difference. It's on Saturday at 10 o'clock UTC time. And yes, in this workshop, we also will go deeper in the new ethical funding policy of the World Cleanup NGO. And we call it Columns of Collaboration. And what's behind that, you will figure out in this workshop. Some examples of ambassadors. One of our ambassadors is Dr. Christine Fickener. She is ambassador in Germany, but also ambassador worldwide. She is situated in Costa Rica. And I will show a short video of her. And she is famous about, she pulled out a straw from a turtle nose last year. It's meanwhile 8 or 10 years in the past, but this goes viral. And for that, she is famous. But meanwhile, she's working on scientist level together with turtles and what she is talking about, collaborations or ambassadorship. We will hear, I hope the video is running.
Depending on where you're based in the world. It is an incredible honor to send greetings to you all in my capacity as an ambassador of World Cleanup Day. Being from Germany, living in Latin America, working with studios and educating people all over the world about the detrimental effects of plastic pollution, I feel a very strong connection to the global mission of Let's Do It World and the World Cleanup Day that are trying to reduce plastic and plastic waste. Because our planet is drowning in plastic. And it is plastic that has been created by our lifestyle of conveniences. It is endangering our wildlife. It is also detrimental to our health. And something has to change. But we won't be able to solve this problem all by ourselves. But we have to start to radically collaborate to work together with all hands on deck in order to fix this plastic pollution crisis. It felt incredibly good to work on a global policy with Let's Do It World that will foster collaborations in the future, while also protecting the initial mission and principles. I, for my part, plan on supporting this movement for many, many more years, and I really hope I can help to make the next World Cleanup Day the largest and most impactful one yet. And in that spirit, I hope you will join us, and I really hope you will stay part of this movement as well. Thank you so much for having me today.
This was on the one hand an example of an ambassador, and now we have here an example of a patron. Also, the president of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, was last year patron in Germany and also worldwide, and spread out our word to be part on World Cleanup Day. And this was the beginning, and what is the outcome also from this? We hear today in the opening speech, a member of the European Parliament, Marion Walsmann, was opening the day. Yes, afterwards, Roberta Metsola, the new president of the European Parliament, also takes over a kind of patronship. This is what we need on global level and local level to create trust. And this is what we did in Germany together, also with the headquarters in Tallinn. How to activate municipalities? Here on the one hand, how to activate in this level, we go into cooperation with the umbrella organization, Deutscher Städte und Gemeindebund. And in the partnership with this organization, it was possible to reach the city mayors and governments of more than 11,000 municipalities. We do that in the last 2 years, or we started 2 years before, but it takes time. Yeah, develop PR together on the one hand with the partner takes time. Such a cooperation needs time, trust, and experience. And what we did also on this level, we start on one of our key communication tools in Germany is the website. And on the website, we have placed a toolbox for municipalities with a direct communication part, how because it's a difference between to communicate with a municipality or with a kid or with a school kid or with a volunteer. So we have several kinds of communication streams placed on this website. Also really cool stop. We are also with our website where gold winner of an international award for the web design, what we did there. And this helps for the communication in direction municipalities. What happened? All these pictures from last year. Here are some pictures from Cologne, from the middle of Germany. And we see the pandemic situation, yes, we know it. We are living in a pandemic situation. But if you have the, if you are the partnership, or if you are in partnership with the municipality, with the schools, and with all these levels, it's possible to make also great events together with the schools, with the sport clubs, with the government. And then, the 5% goal is possible to achieve. On the other hand, we have the development of our school dimension or level, and we create a school project. Wo Klingab de Macht Schule is the name for that. And also here, to go deeper in this topic, there is on Saturday at 6 o'clock p.m. UTC time, we have a keynote session, Best Practices of Environmental Education. In this session, I will go a little bit deeper in this topic, and now I make only top level introduction what we did. We create it's called cleanup kits. You see it here on the picture on the right side. It's a little bit like the idea what's created or what was rolled out in Sweden. We put in this kit gloves, we also a security vest, because the kits goes very often in the area of streets and the cities. So a security vest is for the to save the kids was important. Then it's also a wooden picker inside and some educational stuff for the teachers. This is what we rolled out, and we make it in a beta test last year in Germany. It was a really great success. And we make a contest, so the school classes could apply for this kit, and the kit was for a whole class. And after the class catch the kit, it stays in the school. Yeah, it was very important that it stays in the school in case of the, in view of the sustainable direction. So we let it be in the school, and also for this year and for the next year, the staff is seated there. We go in this year. We think that we arrive round about, also we roll out last year, we arrived around about 3,000 kids. This year we expect 10,000 kids. And it's from the communication level, it was the same like with the municipalities. We go in the center out from our website, and there was a communication kit, and there was shown how easy and participation will be. Also on this topic, the development together with the partners takes time. It's not only done by 1 year. You need time, trust, and experience to develop in this topic. Here are some pictures from the actions in Germany. And you see all the kids have fun, the security vests. Also with this project, it was possible to catch a lot of money from, in this case, 30,000 euro from a lottery and so on. And so we can roll out this project in Germany. Much more information on Saturday in the workshop at 6 o'clock PM UTC time. Lesson learned in Germany. First, focus on 5% goal in our strategy for the actual year and for the next years is really successful. So you can really easy measure how close you are on this target. Second lesson learned is make partner and collaboration chips. This is really important. Also on this level, make ambassador and patron chips. This detail information is also in our World Cleanup Day ethical funding policy, what we create in the last year. And here, this is another hint to the presentation, 10 o'clock UTC time, Green Wash or partnership. Here we will go closer and deeper in this topic. And last but not least, communication. Every time it's communication, but communication with umbrella organizations, with the big ones, and also with the administrative offices in the schools or these levels. It's much easier and faster to reach the huge goal. And you need less resources, less money, and the impact can be a really good result. For the budget, we have in Germany less than 100,000 euro. I have a core team of 5 people, and I have a bigger team what is in every state located. In this level, we have 20, 25 people. It's not much. We are a startup, our organization around about 2-3 years old. So far we are really happy with the results, and yes, it was also really nice to hear about the other leaders, really cool ideas I can bring with home. So far, if some questions, then feel free.
Fantastic. Now, why are we getting sound here? An issue? No, we're back on sound. That was fantastic. Round of applause. Like the Saturday night talk show, I liked your plug for the talk that's coming up as well. Thank you so much. All the way from Germany, originally from the Netherlands. We learned something new today about this gentleman that we didn't know before. He's a man of mystery. And you know what? When the party comes up soon, we're going to learn more about this man of mystery. And we're going to get his hidden talent, his party piece as well, which is exciting. So Holger, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And that's your theme song. I have decided. Next, we're going from Germany and we are going back to Indonesia. Because in Indonesia, we have Andy Barry. Andy Barry, are you there? The co-leader of World Cleanup Day Indonesia. And they're going to be talking about a momentum for an integrated waste bank system. So let's switch from Germany now back to Indonesia.
Hello, can you guys
Hello.
Hear me?
Hello, there he is. Ah, my friend, how are you? Good to see you again.
It's actually Abe. No one knows my nickname, so people thought it's a different person.
Oh, really? So pronounce the name again?
No, actually, it's my initial, Abe.
Abe?
Yeah.
What does your name mean? Since that we've been learning about the different meanings of some names, what does your one mean?
Oh, my name, Andy, I think I remember checking on it. It means warrior, but Bahari, it means the seaman.
Wow.
Or can be mean ocean also, actually.
Oh, well, hang on a second now, Andy. You can only pick one. You're either a warrior, you're the seaman, or you're the ocean. I mean, don't be greedy. Pick one.
Maybe I'm a warrior that live on the islands, so it's
a warrior of you. But you know what? You are a warrior for a greener planet. That's what you're doing. So I suppose you're a warrior for the sea, and you're going to be talking about this momentum for an integrated waste bank system. So I'm fascinated, and I can't wait for you to tell us all about it. And by the way, you look so cool with your cap backwards. I could never pull that off, but you're pulling it off great.
Thank you. So actually, thank you guys. Like, I've been double rolling as an operator and also as a speaker for it, because it's always had something. If I have more love and more information, definitely give out to the world, because I think that's part of my life purpose. But I can give you a quick look of our Indonesian studio if you guys are curious.
Show us. Let's see this. This is behind the scenes. Wow.
I can see myself on screen.
Look at that. Cool. That is so cool.
So there's so many setups going on at the same time as well, trying to check on you guys. But wow. Yeah.
This is like the Eurovision Song Contest here with all this technology and the setup.
Yeah. So yeah.
I keep interrupting you, Andy. Sea Warrior, it's over to you.
Yeah. Yeah, it's almost 12 o'clock midnight, so the Indonesians probably like slowly like dying off to go to the bed. But other place like in Facebook, there's a huge network that going on there. So, but without further ado, hi everyone, I'm Andi Bahari, or people call me Abe. I'm the co-leader of World Cleanup Day Indonesia, and today I will share hopefully something different that you guys never heard of. And let me share my screen. Okay. Okay. So this is my presentations. The title is A Momentum for an Integrated Waste Bank System for Indonesia. So I will continue. So maybe people who don't know about Less Indonesia, probably you guys heard of us so many years without how to put it. Like we just working on it, but somehow we got first place every year with all these all amazing people and teams that working so hard that we got 4 years in a row for the largest contributor for the volunteers. So I will personally want to say thank you to everyone who working so hard from within Indonesia. So we trying to apply whatever visions and missions that from let's do it global or let's do it world and trying to the let's do it Indonesia principle of our vision and mission. So we're doing the same thing with the rest of the world, especially from HQ team Estonia. So for the 4 years straight, we accumulate around 21.4 millions of volunteers and 6,000 is communities and 500 ish corporates and 300 ish universities for 4 years accumulations. So if we break down from the Indonesian's impact from each year, you guys can see that in 2018 we started from like 7-point-something millions to like 14,000 something waste. Tons of waste in Indonesia, and also in 2019 we slightly increasing, but after that to 9.5, and then we stopped dropping down sharply because of the pandemic, and after that we keep dropping until now. But we try to, what we show is not about, so here's the thing, maybe a lot of countries like jealous because oh why Indonesia is so big, so great. Actually, I believe everyone doing their best in their own way. So don't compare. So keep, even though your country is small, but remember whatever the impacts that you guys create is always count. Doesn't matter how big or small it is. So I just want to put it out there that we are not trying to showing off our numbers. So in our first year, all you guys can see, we are focusing on cleanup actions, like totally just clean up. And then after that, in 2019, we start introducing new things. Because Indonesia still not very good in terms of infrastructure, not very good in several like policy making and et cetera. So we still trying to map out the sources of the waste, whereas it's in our household. So we try to introduce waste segregations in 2019. And after that, during pandemic, we believe it's the right way to pick up the momentum to enhance the campaign. So in 2020, we totally focus on waste segregations and start introducing also home-based waste management trainings. And in 2021, we totally trying to integrate everything through also waste bank management. So if you guys can see, like I create a chart that showing that in 2021, we're trying to integrate 1,205 waste bank. Actually, that we have like a lot of waste bank in Indonesia, but we're trying to keep increasing, but that's what the number that we have last year. So this is like sort of like a roadmap, like we're trying to map out the problem, so all the way starting from the citizens or the household itself, and then if we are doing the waste segregations, so some partially of the waste will go to the residual and landfill. So we're trying to push that down. So, but most of the waste, which is like food waste and recyclable waste, can be processing. So food waste can be processing into, you know, like composting, and after that it can be put for the planting. So that will result for the clean environment. So same as also for waste segregations, if we recycle our items in Indonesia, it have benefits that you can collect and put it in the waste bank, and the waste bank can sell it, and it will also sell it to the waste traders or the company. So all these systems can be more circular. So we want to achieve the circular economy soon or later. So in that way, we want to show the citizen that there's an opportunity or there's economical benefit in terms of waste, because people always treat waste as waste, but never see it on a different side of it. So this is what we're trying to do. So for the next, beside the roadmap, we have the pie chart for the percentage of the ratio of the each type of waste in Indonesia. So in pre-pandemic, we have like 60% of like organic waste and 14% like plastic and paper, 9%, and then 4% metal, and et cetera, et cetera. But after during the pandemic, we have a huge increase of plastic waste and organic waste. Actually, it's not decreasing, but just the percentage, but actually it's like quite similar. But because during pandemic, everyone using plastic, singles, blah, 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 that we cannot escape from. So it's a huge increasement. So from these trends, it makes us even more push us further to trying to tackle this issue, which is trying to sort it through each one household and participants and run through all the program to the waste banks integrated system. So at the right side, you guys can see there's several photos, a lot of actually thousand and thousand of housewife doing waste segregation at home, and they're trying to get benefit out of the waste, which is good because we believe in Indonesia every wife is the one who holding the waste and processing the waste. So if we can get all the moms working on this, we can sort of all the problems for the Indonesian's waste. But Indonesia's achievement, beside all of that waste bank integrated system that last year that we achieved, we also have a huge network of leaders and team nature. Maybe this is one of our secrets for being have a huge impact. Doesn't matter if it's a pandemic, doesn't matter if it's not pandemic. So we're still trying to move forward because in each of our provinces, we have our strong leaders across of Indonesia. Every single province have leaders. And also in district level, we have like 200 is leaders across Indonesia, and we have more than 2,000 of core team members across Indonesia. So this is how we keep producing millions of numbers, even though the situations is not supporting us even right now. So beside our great leaders to integrate our system, we also need a support system, because we cannot work this only solely from the NGO side or only the citizen. So we also need to integrate the whole waste bank system. It's also because we have a huge, strong support system from the government, such as Ibu Rosa, the Secretary General of from the Forestry, Minister of Forestry of and Agriculture of Indonesia. They are one of the most strongest supporters of Indonesia working at Bay movement. So we have four ministry level of support that support the whole country's movement, and we have two huge supporting level from the governor level also in provincial level. So in each year, we're trying to map out more and more government, more and more collaborator, more and more like community, try to get more people on board. Even the volunteers numbers going down, but our support from the governments and the community have been increasing exponentially every single year. So this is our main report from the last year, because this is only from the national team side. So we held 34 lives with 12,000-ish views, and we have 53 speakers. Webinars, we have 23 webinars with more than 5,000 attendees with 57 speakers. And we have medias across the nation, we got 78, and the local medias, we got 91. From the Soli last year main event that fall on the September last year. So because we have so many adversities for the past 2 years, so me and team and everyone on the national team trying to create a more diverse program to strengthen all the circular economy and all these waste bank integrated system with a more diverse program that can support the whole integrated system. So we have in Indonesia, we have three core campaigns. We put forward first is real actions, because we cannot do anything without real examples. So we have to go to the field, get yourself dirty, showing up on anywhere, even online or offline, just do the real campaign. So basically that's our core, number one core campaign value. So we are the our own agent of change. And then the next one, we're trying to become with WCD Indonesia is advocating. So we want to encourage corporates and also government body to change deeper and further. And also the last one, but not least, is educating everyone's through the, especially the youth, to improve the social and behavioral change within the society. So here in WCD Indonesia, we really, really trying to push forward with the CSR or ESG programs with different body, especially from the corporate stakeholders. So here you guys can see, we're not only doing cleanups, we only move beyond that. So now we have a lot of different type of programs. We have building decluttering programs where we just have the decluttering program with the Netherlands Embassy last month. So we also doing digital cleanup. Actually today I just doing presentations on digital cleanup this morning also. And then we keep doing the waste segregation. So we're also doing partially natural rehabilitations, and we're also trying to do impact measurements. And we always keep doing webinars, workshops, and training. So we challenge us. We're always trying to find a way to move forward and create more. One door got shut, we create 10 doors to can be open. So that's what we do. We keep our spirit high up. So beside that, because waste bank integrated systems can get really complex, so we definitely also working with a lot of third parties, with our partners, especially Indorelawan. And Indorelawan is one of the largest online volunteer platform in Indonesia. So here, this is how we get all the hundred thousands or 10,000s of the moms and people who work remotely through online through these portals. And also we also work with Smash. Smash is also one of the main gateway who map up all the waste bank in Indonesia. So this is how also we get all the database of the waste bank across Indonesia from Aceh to Papua, to get all the waste bank on board to support with our movement. And also similar with Bebas ID. Bebas ID is basically Bebas Sampah ID is basically also the collaborative platform that become the informative portal that enhance and also inflict collaborations for the whole Indonesia national waste management system. So Indonesia, actually, we don't work by ourselves. How we get big is because we're trying to get everyone on board as much as we can to create what we achieved last year we successfully created a movement that focused on the waste bank integrated system. So maybe that's just my quick short overview about success story for Indonesia last year. Thank you for making it possible for your all support, because you attend, and so we can share with each other with our love and all the amazing people. Like, actually quite sad because we couldn't do this offline, but at least we can still share our love with each other through online, and we still all here and together, and we still moving forward to create the people, to create the planet, planet for cleaner planet. So yeah, thank you everyone.
Thank you so much, Andy. That was fantastic. The crowd is going wild, Andy. Thank you for sharing with us your wisdom and all your points about the success stories in Indonesia. And because we're over time and we still have some great speakers to hear from, including one of my favorites, Bill from the USA, we are going to keep on moving. So Andy, thank you so much once again. And thank you for all the background work you're doing with all the technology streaming there on YouTube and Facebook. And have I missed anywhere else?
I think, Facebook and YouTube and Zoom.
Zoom as well, Instagram. Of course. And Instagram.
No, Instagram. We don't.
Instagram, we don't. Agustina, get with the program. Thank you so much. Our warrior of the sea, sailing the seven seas. Talk to you soon, Andy. Bye.
Bye. Thank you, everyone.
Bye. Now we are moving from Indonesia. We are heading to Brazil, and we are going to talk to Edelina Fernandez Pereira. And the title of this talk is The Before and After of the Beginning of the World Cleanup Day Campaign in Brazil. And Edelina is the leader of Brazil, executive director of the Instituto Limpa Brasil. So I think we are going to speak to her through a translator as well called Pedro. So let's see, come in. Do you hear me, Pedro?
Hey, I'm hearing you.
You're hearing me. How are you, Pedro?
Hi, I wanted to say hello for everyone. I already heard what a lot of people had to say, and I'm very glad and honored to be here today, representing my country and representing the movement that I participate in.
Well, let me check. Are you the translator? You're not the translator. No, you were speaking directly. You were Edelina.
Yeah. So what happens? I am the leader of the division of ambassadors from Limpa Brasil, specificated for underage, for minors, you know? So today I work with a lot of other teenagers trying to clean and trying to educate Brazilians towards lowering the garbage and the trash in the streets, you know?
That is fantastic. And how do I pronounce your name?
It's Pedro, but you can say Pedro. I know it's kind of hard.
Pedro. And what age are you, Pedro?
What?
What age are you?
So I'm 16 right now, and right now, how I had said already, I lead the movement for teenagers in Brazil. It's called Jovens que Limpam, which translating would be the youth that cleans, something like that.
And is it easy to get teenagers involved and engaged, or are they interested in too many other things, Pedro?
So, incredibly speaking, it's kind of easy to talk with teenagers. We have this wrong vision that teenagers don't care about the environment, but it's totally the opposite. Everyone, every teenager cares about the world. Everybody knows that we must do something for continue to living in this planet. But the thing is, sometimes it's very complicated to get into the environmental, to get into ecological fight, because it's really bureaucratic, especially when you are underage. So my mission within Limpa Brasil is to make the process easy for making the participation of teenage people inside the movement to be something easy, so something that everyone can do.
That is fantastic. And you know what, Pedro, I can hear the passion in your voice. I love it. And in your smile as well. So I won't interrupt you anymore. I'll let you get ahead with your presentation. The before and after of the beginning of the World Cleanup Day campaign in Brazil. It's over to you, Pedro.
So I think Adlani has already is already presenting. So let me check here. Pode falar, Adlani.
To the people watching now that Pedro is going to be translating here, live translating, while Edelina is giving the presentation.
So Edelani has said to everyone, good afternoon, and she's now starting the presentation.
Eu fiz questão, né, mesmo não falando inglês, de participar desta conferência para contar um pouquinho minha experiência, né, que eu já estou no movimento há 10 anos. E contar um pouco de como foi, né, iniciar no movimento antes do Dia Mundial da Limpeza e como que é vivenciar agora com a campanha do Dia Mundial da Limpeza.
So, Edelaine saying that she made sure that she was participating in this meeting because even though she doesn't speak English, she has a lot to say about her experience in the movement and all the things that the Brazilian part of the Let's Do It movement is doing, so for the prevention of the, urban cleaning.
Tentando compartilhar aqui, mas está falhando, está travando um pouco o meu notebook.
She's saying that she's trying to present, but her notebook, her laptop is giving some problems with connection, but she's trying to present.
Para seguir aqui enquanto, né, a apresentação não abre, vamos falar um pouquinho, né, quando começamos nas ações aqui no Brasil, no ano de 2011, ainda não tínhamos muitos países participando do Let's Do It, do movimento Let's Do It, e não tínhamos também experiência de países grandes, assim como o Brasil. Se eu não me falha a memória, o país que tinha, né, que estava já fazendo parte do movimento que era grande assim como o Brasil, era o México.
So she said that before she starts to present because of the connection problems, she wanted to give some introduction. So basically, the movement started in Brazil in 2011, when not many countries have already engaged themselves with the Let's Do It movement. The only big country that she said it was in was only Mexico. So Brazil was kind of a trailblazer within the movement with a big country, you know? So, pode continuar.
E a gente queria chamar a atenção da sociedade aqui no Brasil para que elas enxergassem, né, que tinha lixo jogado fora do lixo. Então, a gente criou aí uma campanha chamada O Mundo Ficou Pequeno Demais para Tanto Lixo.
So, the movement in Brazil was made to make everyone pay attention that there were garbage outside the garbage can. There was trash in the nature, in the streets, and it was made for make everyone pay attention with the pollution that was being caused by that.
Porque, na verdade, para a gente limpar, a gente tinha que enxergar que estava sujo. Pelas nossas cidades ter aí um grande número de resíduos descartados de forma inadequada, a gente achou melhor começar por uma campanha despertando e convidando as pessoas para serem catadores por um dia.
So she said that before cleaning, it was necessary to make everyone see that it was dirty. So the movement started by making campaigns make everyone see that there was pollution, so we could clean it. So the first main action of Limpa Brasil was to make everyone be a trash collector for one day. So it would make everyone to see how dirty our streets were, to make everyone see how much work was necessary to clean our country. Pode continuar.
E aí a gente tinha várias personalidades que vestiram essa camisa, né, de ser catador por um dia e sair para limpar sua cidade, assim como uma pessoa que é conhecida, inclusive internacionalmente, um dos nossos cantores aqui no Brasil, Chico Buarque, e a gente também teve aqui no Brasil a visita do Jack Johnson na época, e na oportunidade ele também vestiu a camiseta do Eu Sou Catador.
So, with the action of being a trash collector for one day, some public personalities have engaged themselves, such as the famous Brazilian singer Chico Buarque and other international personalities. Let's continue.
Deixa eu ver se eu vou compartilhar aqui, eu quero passar esse vídeo.
So right now she's trying to make the video go on.
A gente vai ter o áudio, né?
Pedro, I might suggest that if we if the streaming is not working for the computer, then maybe she could just speak from the heart and you could translate, because she's coming across very well now in telling her story and the country's story.
Okay. Então, Edi, disseram que caso o computador não esteja funcionando, a gente pode ir falando assim do coração e tal, aí eu vou traduzindo.
Tá bom, tá dando para ouvir o som aqui? Tá dando para ver o vídeo?
O vídeo não, para mim não tá. So she asked.
Compartilhando.
So is anyone seeing the video that she's presenting?
No, we're not seeing the video. We were just seeing the PowerPoint, but it was not full screen. Now we're seeing something being shared now, and we're waiting for it to load. Yes, we see a YouTube video.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Eles estão vendo. Pode começar.
A gente colocou lixo dentro do metrô na cidade do Rio de Janeiro para mostrar para as pessoas que o mundo estava ficando pequeno demais para tanto lixo.
So what they did was to put a lot of trash, a lot of garbage, plastic bags in the Rio de Janeiro subway system. So everyone could see that the world was becoming too small for that amount of trash. Was a campaign for the raising the people's awareness about the problem with pollution, especially in Rio de Janeiro, where we have problems with trash in the beaches, streets, and like such as all the other towns in Brazil.
Em 2018, né, a gente começou aí a campanha do Dia Mundial da Limpeza, e aqui no Brasil a gente tem um co-líder chamado Jean Peliciari, e a gente mobilizou também outros líderes aqui no Brasil. Então a gente tem líderes em várias cidades do Brasil que participam das ações do Dia Mundial da Limpeza e realizam as ações nas suas cidades.
So in 2018, Limpa Brasil has started to the campaign of the World Cleanup Day with the co-leader Jean Parisacci and with other leaders in a lot of other Brazilian towns. So we have these actions and with a lot of cities and towns around the country.
Então nós somos líderes de mobilização Limpa Brasil, né, e o Jean, e aí os líderes realizam as ações nas suas cidades e a gente também realiza aí nas localidades que nós estamos presentes.
So with this leader, Jean, and all the other leaders around the country, we make actions in our own home count, in our own home cities, and around the country as a whole.
E aí a gente tem resultados assim de participações dos municípios. A gente tem um país que tem um pouco mais de 5 mil municípios, e já na primeira edição do Dia Mundial da Limpeza, a gente contou com a participação de 363 municípios. Em 2019, a gente partiu para 1.200 municípios participantes das ações do Dia Mundial da Limpeza.
So, we live in a country, Brazil has over 5 1,000 municipalities. And in the first edition of the World Cleanup Day, we could achieve the mark of 300 cities engaged on the movement. And in 2019, over 1,200 cities participated in the World Cleanup Day. So we were seeing a lot of progress in this field.
E mesmo aqui no período de pandemia, né, no ano de 2020, 2021, que a gente pediu para as pessoas não fazerem mutirões de limpeza e não saírem às ruas, nós tivemos ações que foram realizadas para as pessoas realizarem a partir das suas casas, e a gente teve aí uma grande adesão dos municípios, né, 934 municípios no ano de 2020, e a gente chegou aí a 987 municípios no ano de 2021. Uma coleta de resíduos de mutirões de limpeza de mais de 320 mil quilos de resíduos e também de ecopontos, já que a gente convida as pessoas a separarem os resíduos e entregarem nessas localidades para que a gente faça a destinação adequada.
So, even in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we were able to mobilize over 300 cities in 2020 and over 400 cities in 2021. And we were able to pick up over 320,000 of pounds of garbage in our movement. And we were also involved in the creation of eco points where people could discarded garbage in a sustainable way, recycling, and, you know, in a way that it doesn't go to the streets.
E aqui no Brasil a gente já tem aí, as pessoas já têm na sua agenda, né, gravado a data do Dia Mundial da Limpeza. Então, cada vez mais cedo, né, os municípios começam a se articular. A gente tem municípios e estados aqui no Brasil que já começaram a se movimentar para as ações desse ano, como, por exemplo, o estado do Rio Grande do Norte.
So, today, people have already in their minds that the World Cleanup Day is going to happen. And the municipalities and even the states are beginning to prepare themselves each time sooner. So, we have already municipalities and states that have already begun to prepare themselves for this year World Cleanup Day, such as the state of Rio Grande do Norte. In the northeastern region of Brazil.
Aqui no Brasil, a gente também fez, né, além da limpeza de mutirões de limpezas, que a gente chama da limpeza ambiental, nós fizemos também ações da limpeza solidária, a limpeza digital e a limpeza mental.
So, here in Brazil, despite the environmental cleaning, we have already made solidarity cleanings and digital cleanings that was meant to be for other spectrums of garbage, such as digital garbage and, you know, distributing food for families in need, etc.
E nós temos aqui também uma categoria de profissionais que são os catadores de materiais recicláveis, né? Aqui 90% dos resíduos que são separados e destinados para a coleta seletiva é feita por essas pessoas. A gente tem mais de 2 milhões de pessoas aqui no Brasil, então a gente também trabalha destinando esses resíduos e estimulando a sociedade que destine esses resíduos para as cooperativas de catadores de materiais recicláveis, e a gente consegue trabalhar dessa forma a inclusão social e a geração de renda.
So, other thing that we do here in Brazil is to connect the recyclable material collectors with our actions. In Brazil, we have over 2 million recyclable material collectors, and they are responsible for over 90% of the recyclable materials collection. So it's really important for us to make this social inclusion by making them receive our materials and all our other results from our actions.
E uma das atividades educativas que a gente faz aqui no Brasil é transformar escolas em ecopontos, que seriam escolas que têm ali um espaço para recebimento de resíduos separados para coleta seletiva. Então, as pessoas têm ali a educação ambiental na escola, nós fazemos palestras, eles fazem a separação dos resíduos nas suas residências e levam para a escola para que esse resíduo possa ser destinado de forma adequada. Então, a gente faz a conscientização E aí o aluno pode fazer a prática separando na sua casa para destinar esses resíduos de forma adequada.
So other thing we do here in Brazil is the educational actions, where we turn schools into eco points, where we can make students deliver their home trash in their own schools for recycling. And the whole school become an engagement point where children and young people can learn about recycling and connect with with the trash collectors and etc.
Então, nós demos um salto, né? Quando você olha aí as ações que foram realizadas antes do início do Dia Mundial da Limpeza e pós-Dia Mundial da Limpeza, a gente vê que existiu um grande avanço aqui no Brasil. E isso, a minha percepção é que é em decorrência da mobilização mundial, o impacto que isso tem e o tanto que isso é importante para as ações que a gente realiza aqui no Brasil. Essa junção de todas as pessoas e de todos os países.
So in the last years, Limpa Brazil have really progressed a lot. We have great numbers since the beginning of World Cleanup Day, and today we are able to reach a whole different level of people right here in our country, and we have hope to keep progressing with our numbers and our activities.
E assim como, né, acreditamos muito que a força da sociedade tem um poder de mudar tudo e a gente só vai conseguir realmente resgatar e trazer uma qualidade ambiental para as nossas cidades se a gente tiver a junção e a união da sociedade.
So we believe in society's strength to change the world and we know that the only way to provide environmental quality is to make the whole society learn how to treat nature well and to make everyone happy with a better life quality.
Eu acredito também que o resultado das ações do Dia Mundial da Limpeza já tem uma força de mudar também o inconsciente coletivo, porque apesar da gente ter aí as ações planejadas, quando vai chegando próximo da ação, parece que acontece um arrastão e as pessoas começam a aderir ao movimento para o Dia Mundial da Limpeza.
So we also believe that all of our actions can affect the unconsciousness of the society, because when one person engage itself themselves with our actions, we see a whole we see a lot of other people from the same region getting to know what we do and getting to change the world by themselves too. So when one person mobilizes tons of people comes with it.
E aí a nossa responsabilidade de deixar um legado para as novas gerações, por isso que estamos desenvolvendo aqui no Brasil o grupo de jovens, né, os jovens até 18 anos, assim como o Pedro que está aqui, que é o presidente nacional desse movimento, para que a gente possa mobilizar aí e contribuir para a mentoria das futuras gerações.
So we also concern about what we're going to leave as a legacy for the younger generations. That's why we have a underage group called Jovens que Limpam, led by me, where young people up to 18 years old get to learn and get to act in environmental actions around Brazil.
Pietro, just to let you know that you are almost out of time.
Great. So, Edilene, eu avisaram que a gente está quase sem tempo, então, para a gente já ir finalizando.
A gente já finalizou, então, a gente só quer agradecer a participação e ficar aqui à disposição de todos.
So, we have already ended what we had to say. We wanted to thank everyone for being here and to listen to us, and we wanted to say that we are here to help this world movement towards the globe cleaning, you know? So thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you to Endelina there in Brazil and to 16-year-old Pedro, very smart young man, for doing the translation as well and for leading the teenagers of Brazil in the movement. Thank you so much, guys. And we are moving on now. We've two left to go, Cameroon. But first, we are talking to the United States of America. The beautiful, wonderful country that is the USA, and the beautiful, wonderful Bill Bill, beautiful. I know you're not in the USA. You are over in Estonia. Let's do exactly. It. Headquarters. I can't see your face, Bill, and that won't do because you're a handsome man.
Oh, when yeah. No. You haven't had enough alcohol to call me handsome, so.
Bill, I've been drinking all day when the speakers have been on. No, that's not. There's Bill, everybody. Yes, Bill. Oh, wonderful, Bill. Listen, and look at the colors behind you, Bill, and the, look at this. What is, are you in a nightclub?
Actually, I've got, the French contingency there.
It looks like you guys have been drinking already.
Not yet, but as soon as I get through, you're missing out. I brought a Cabernet from Napa Valley.
Oh.
So as soon as I get through, we're going to be opening that up.
Some people have all the fun. Well, look at this, Bill. You've got a professional mic on. You've got like a TV set behind you. You're lit to perfection. You look like you're 15 years of age. And you're about to give us a wonderful talk and an inspiring talk. So, Bill, no one wants to hear me natter. I'm going to hand it over to you.
Oh, good.
Over to Alrighty. You.
I was told to keep it short, so I will. Basically, I'm going to talk about developing partnerships. When I first got here, we started up with World Cleanup Day in 2017 when it first started, and we had no idea what we were doing or how to do it. And what we decided not to go the government route. We decided to go to small business, to cities, to other partnerships with like Earth Day and Keep America Beautiful. And we found out what happens is that people will work with you as long as they see a positive movement. In other words, we've been called the cheerleaders of cleanups. And we got groups together that never talked to each other before. And we found that people want to do something, they just didn't know how to do it. And cleanups are what I call the gateway drug into developing the whole, let's keep the world clean, as it were. The cleanups are the easiest thing to do. People say, we want to save the, and fill in the blank, save the snakes, save the turtles, save whatever. That's hard to do, but you can do a cleanup. And small companies can get together, and they found out by doing that, by getting together to do a cleanup, they got camaraderie, they got all the wonderful things, feeling good. And there's a thing called social marketing that's built in, that when people clean up, they like it. They see the area clean up. They want to keep it that way. And on our board is a lady who is a litterologist, one of eight in the world. And they say litter begets litter. When people see litter, they don't feel bad about putting litter down. When they see that people are cleaning up, they think twice about doing it. And then once they've cleaned up, they want to keep it clean. Then it becomes theirs. And then they become a movement. And then people want to join in. So we started off with merely our first year with only 250,000 people participating. And we've gone up as high as 2 million people. And we're doing, even in COVID, in the worst times, we did over 650,000 people doing small cleanups. And it was easy. Once people knew about it, the whole idea is to get the word out. Once people knew about it, once they saw that they could participate, it wasn't hard. And remember, our battle cry for National Cleanup Day, which I have here, which is part of World Cleanup Day, is if you're not having fun, you're doing it wrong. And Colm, you know me, we have fun, don't we?
So we certainly do.
The whole point in this is, get a group, they have fun, they will continue doing it, and you will grow. And that's how it does. We go to all the shows, all the outdoor retail shows. We find people, we say, how would you like to make the world a better place? And it's easy to do. And they join in. Small companies, large companies, it doesn't matter to us. They all join in. And it's a group effort. The Chinese have a word. It's called guanxi. It means relationships. It means we're all in this together. We should be bailing the boat out, not drilling holes in the bottom of it. So people want to do this. They want to join it. So do you have any questions, my dear sir?
Yes, that's good. Let's put it out to the crowd and see if anyone has a question for Bill. If you do, please type it in the comments section and Bill should be able to see it there on the screen, or I will see it here on my screen. Bill, it's always good to talk to you. Someone here says, Bill, love you. And there you go. And love that quote. Hello, Bill. I missed your fun too much. So happy to see you. This is all just love mail and fan mail for you, Bill.
I like it.
If you want. But anyone have a question for Bill and how they do this in the United States, how they create partnerships and get people working together? Although what you said, Bill, was pretty self-explanatory. You make people want to have fun. You emphasize the goodness in this. It is something good for the environment. And who wouldn't want to get involved in that? And isn't it true, Bill, that now, even if their motives are not that pure, that every cooperation, every organization wants to be seen as
well? You see, nowadays we don't judge. That's one of the things we don't do. We don't put somebody down. We look at what they do. It's motives. I mean, my motives have never been pure, but anyways, we look at what people have done, what they want to do, and we give them a chance. I think that's the most important thing, is to give people a chance to prove that they can make the world a better place.
That's a good question, Bill, because some people in previous years here at the World Cleanup Day and at the conference were wondering and questioning some of the partners because of the kind of work they were involved in, maybe their track record on environmental issues. And they were saying, we can't allow them into Let's Do It or be part of the World Cleanup Day because look at what they're involved in day in and day out. So when do you turn and say, you know what, we're not letting you be part of our cleanup because of X, Y, Z? Or is it you can't police that, so you just say you want to be involved and help out? Yes, you can.
Well, a perfect example is Keep America Beautiful, okay? Their funding comes from various sources that people would say they're greenwashing, but no, they do a wonderful job. They're well-known. They've got groups out there that do fantastic jobs. And so it's more important the job they do than who funds them.
Good point. Tanswell asks a question, Bill. Have you and your team ever connected with the national parks?
Oh, yes. That's okay. See, when I say government groups, we don't work directly with government, but we do work with the national parks. They are fantastic people. And they have their own rules. And so what we do is we work within that. So National Cleanup Day and World Cleanup Day are very important because what we're allowing is people to clean up under a banner. So they're doing something. See, very important. This is very important. If you told your child you have to clean up your room every day, they don't do it, right? But if you say, pick one day a year to clean it up, they will do it, and then they want to keep their room clean. And this is where the national parks come in. They're wonderful people.
Bill, I've only one thing left to say to you, and that is... Shut up. I'm sorry I had to do it.
It's wonderful. It's great.
Bill, you're fantastic, and we'll talk to you at the party. We're having a little party in just a few minutes because we're going on to our last speaker, and be sure we're going to talk to Bill at the party. You know, everyone talks to Bill at the party.
Yep, I'm going to have a party here.
So now we're
nice
going
to see you again.
You too. Good to see you, Bill. Always a pleasure. Bill is the man. Thank you, Bill. And we're
Thank
going
you,
now
sir.
To Cameroon. We had some technical issues a while ago, our last speaker of the day, so hopefully we have fixed them as we go back to Cameroon. And we're going to talk about Nature is Gold and Nature is God. Nanjanjo, I've pronounced that so badly. Can you hear me? Now, Cameroon, do you hear me?
Thank you for hello. Yeah, I'm yes. here. I'm back again. Thank you for bringing me back, Bill, Colm. I was calling you, Bill, already. I miss Bill already.
So now, we can hear you, but I think your internet is very poor because it is breaking up. Do you have your presentation? And if not your presentation, maybe you could turn your camera on and just speak for a few moments about the cleanup there.
The internet is too good. That's beyond my control.
I totally understand.
I'm ready now. So I can share the presentation. Yes. Okay.
Now, we are ready. I've been told by our technical people that you can share your presentation. We may have to try tomorrow, and I understand it's out of your control, the internet connection. So we will wait and see for a few moments. I think we've lost our connection with you altogether, I see, with Cameroon. I think we might have. And thank you for bearing with us, by the way, everybody, because when you're doing live links to Estonia, to Germany, to Indonesia, to the United States, you will always have this because the internet connection, of course, varies from place to place. And yes, okay, we will skip and we will go back tomorrow to Cameroon. It's been confirmed. So guys, thank you so much. We are about to finish officially the first day of the Let's Do It World Conference. We'll continue again tomorrow. We've got some great speakers. Hold on a second. Don't go anywhere because we have a party to get to. We're about to end the live stream on YouTube and Facebook. So if you're watching on YouTube and Facebook, it is goodbye right now. We can't live stream the party because a party is a party. So goodbye to everybody watching online, and we'll see you tomorrow for more great speakers and more great ideas for the world. Let's Do It World Conference. Pause for a moment and let them end the streams. Okay, everybody, let's relax for a few minutes and get to know each other. I'm going to just put you all on my screen here so we can start to chat. We want to get everyone involved here. Hang on a second now, everybody. Everyone stay calm. We have Bill's camera. It is pinned to the screen. It should not be. Let's get the gallery view on. Here we go. Now we're talking. I can see everybody. So, that was a good first day.